He's won seven straight in this series between the Baltimore Ravens and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Happy holidays, everyone, with Randy Cross. This is Kevin Harlan. Baltimore can make the playoffs if they win and get a lot of help from five other teams in the NFL today. Pittsburgh has won the division. This is a team that has already made the playoffs. They can get home field if they win and if Tennessee loses, and a bye would be included in there possibly as well. Those are big stakes for the Steelers. How do you see today?
Well, you know, the days of the Neanderthal football are dead here in Pittsburgh. It's fast break football. It's two-minute football from the get-go with the Tommy Gun offense and Maddox just chunking this ball all over the place and then setting it up for the running game later. Baltimore's biggest challenge all goes to their defensive backs. If there's any one guy it goes to even more than anybody else, it's Chris McAllister. He's going to see Plexico Burress a lot. Burress has had big games against this team. How he does or doesn't do will decide how this game goes.
We'll come back to Pittsburgh after this. You're watching the NFL on CBS. For the Ravens and the Steelers. Happy New Year, everyone. Baltimore has won 3 of 5. Pittsburgh, the division champs, have won 4 of 5 overall.
Oh my goodness.
Subway presents Fresh Starts, a salute to this season's surprises. Subway, eat fresh.
Coach Marty Schottenheimer has a successful youth movement in San Diego with over 16.
Beautiful Heinz Field here in Pittsburgh. It is a bit breezy, but 34 degrees Beasley Reese, and pretty good weather conditions as we go to you on the sideline.
All right, thanks a lot, Kevin. Keep your eye on running back Jamal Lewis of the Ravens today. He's had a fantastic season, but something has got to give. The Steelers are ranked number one in rush defense. Jamal has 1,241 yards rushing. If you add that to his receiving prowess, he represents 40% of the Ravens' offense. His success today will be key to their chances. Back to you.
All right, Beasley, thank you very much. Chester Taylor is deep back and awaiting the kickoff from Jeff Reed, who is a rookie free agent from North Carolina, who Randy has come in and seemingly shored up whatever kicking problems this team had.
And has not had problems kicking in Heinz Field. We have played Chris Brown, the last kicker here, especially going into this open end he's kicking into right now.
Chester Taylor is back, the Ravens and Steelers, and here we go. And from the 14-yard line, Taylor. And brought down on the play. Flag has been thrown as well. A 16-yard return. Chris Hope made the special teams tackle for the Pittsburgh Steelers. You think it's a hold?
Yeah, it's going to be a hold against Baltimore, so Jeff Blake and company gets to back up for a while.
Ron Winter is our referee.
They're going to return. Holding. Number 49 of the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
The Baltimore offense is the 27th ranked offense in the NFL. Leading him is Jeff Blake, who is starting his 10th consecutive game today. From the 20, it is first and 10 for the Ravens, who come in 7-8. Good time for Blake, airing it out, looking for Heap on the side. What a catch by Todd Heap. Their Pro Bowl tight end racing down the side to the Steeler 39, picking up 41 yards on the play.
This is the ISO that really that Heap and company want. They want Todd Heap working against the safety Flowers. Flowers cannot stay with Todd Heap. Pittsburgh has got to put a corner on Todd Heap, who can't, then he can't run by him. Then they have to worry about the jump ball. But at least he can't run by a corner, because he can run by a safety if you see it.
That was his 62nd reception of the season. So inside the Pittsburgh 39, it is a first down for Baltimore as Blake gives off to Jamal Lewis, who dances a bit. First time he met the Steelers, a season low 34 yards. He picks up 4 yards right there. So we told you about quarterback Jeff Blake. Jonathan Ogden on that line going to his sixth consecutive Pro Bowl. He is alone and maybe the best in the NFL right now. And Todd Heap just hauled in that great reception. He, too, is going to the Pro Bowl. Second down and six with a couple of tight ends from the 34. And Jamal Lewis right into the grasp of Kendrell Bell. It's a gain of eight, and it's a first down for the Baltimore Ravens. Now Pittsburgh's defense. This is the number one run defense in the NFL. Aaron Smith on that line, but Casey Hampton is an emerging star. Joey Porter has 9 sacks in the linebacking core. James Ferrier, by the way, out today. Mike Brown taking his place. And Dwayne Washington leaves the secondary for the Steelers. It is first down and 10. Little handoff down to the 25 and a gain of a yard. And it goes off to Allen Recall and only his 12th carry of the year.
Something that's really kind of, I guess, insignificant at times, but also can tell you things, are the atmosphere before a game, especially the pregame introductions. Pittsburgh came kind of strutting out of their tunnel. I mean, just sort of low running and strutting. Baltimore's been fired up from the get-go, and right now, Bill Cowher's football team is kind of on their heels and still kind of in strut mode.
Second down and 9. On the 25, they blow that gap. Some movement on the line.
Yeah, it's going to be right tackle Ethan Brooks trying to get an early start.
77 offense. 5-yard penalty. And then second down.
Yeah, I don't blame Brooks for doing that. You know, he saw Jason Taylor earlier this year and had a hard time with him. And over on that right offensive side, he's got Jason Gildon coming on his side, number 92 from the outside linebacker position. And, you know, Brian Billick, that's got to be a matchup that concerns Brian in protecting his quarterback, keeping Gildon off his quarterback.
I'll push it back to the 30 where it's second down and 14. Blake, that's a nice block. Porter's down, and here comes Blake, who fires to Heap, who's inside the 10, grabbed by Jones, tumbles for a gain of 22 to the Steelers' 7-yard line. Randy, the Pittsburgh defense, the only defense in the NFL that is not giving up an opening game touchdown this year.
You know, Gildon doesn't slow up Heap at all, and Jeff Blake last night was very honest with us, and instead of saying, well, I go from read one to read two to read three in my progression, he pretty much admits, when I see a play call, I look at the defense, and then I say, okay, where's Todd Heap?
It's first and goal from the 8. Game-opening drive for Baltimore. A fake to Lewis. Here they come. Lee Flowers douses Blake back at about the 16-yard line is where they will officially mark it. Lee Flowers come flying in. That's his 4th sack of the season, a loss of 9.
Well, the easy part to realize here is you look at blockers. 1, 2, 3, 4. This side, 4 people on this side with a running back here. Okay? Who's going to block who? You're bringing 4. You've only got 3 to block. Lee Flowers completely uncontested. That's just, they're bringing more than you can block.
And no defensive back in the NFL has 4 sacks. He's got the most. Second down and goal from the 16. They got Chester Taylor out of the backfield in motion. And Blake with the block by Brooks. Dumps it off, called by Ricard. He gets his 9th reception of the season. It's a gain of 2. And he's at about the 14-yard line.
The Ricard's been a nice surprise, I think, for Brian Billick's offense. When you consider, they brought Sam Gash in here to be sort of the mentor fullback, to be the guy that's, you know, arguably one of the better lead blockers that's been in this league over the last 10 years. And Ricard showed not only can he lead block, he's a good receiver. If they give him the ball, he knows what to do with it.
One back, that's Taylor. It's 3rd and goal from the 14.
Keep an eye on Todd Heap, top of your screen.
Among those 3, you're right at the top. A fake to Taylor, who offers a block. Here comes Jerry Porter. And there goes the pass in the end zone. Intercepted to Shea Townsend. His 3rd interception of the season.
We told you Todd Heap lined up at the very far side of the formation. Blake got in trouble. He said, where's Heap? Well, there he was. He didn't come down with the ball.
Shea Townsend just picked off Blake in the end zone. And from the 20-yard line, It is first and 10. Tommy Maddox to aim a zero away. The flea flicker, a bad pitch back. Here comes the rush by Brown and the incomplete pass. Boy, they leveled Maddox. I mean, squished him. It'll be second and 10.
Let's go back to that last interception by Jeff Blake. Really, the pressure comes from right here from Joey Porter, who's going to end up over in the right side of the offensive backfield, just chasing Jeff Blake. He's looking for Heap. 50-50 chance of coming down with it when you throw it to the big tight end, but he couldn't get enough loft on it for Heap to get it because of the pressure backside.
Intentional
Porter.
Grounding. Penalized 10 yards. And a loss of down.
Intentional grounding on Tommy Maddox.
That's an excellent call, too, because Maddox was in that pocket the whole way, and he just dumped that right in front of Brian Billick. Brian Billick was actually the closest person to that play.
Well, Brian Billick was a college tight end at BYU. I can see why.
Well, he'd have caught it. You see that? Nobody in the general area.
All right, now it's second down and 20. Jerome Bettis, by the way, not playing. We'll give you the lineups in just a second on the offense. He's got an injury and will not suit up. Second and 20, back at the 10 with the Pittsburgh penalty. Come at him again. That was deflected. The rush up the middle coming from Anthony Weaver, who is a rookie defensive lineman from Notre Dame, number 98. Pittsburgh offense, number 5 in the NFL. They've been in the top 7 NFL offenses the last 2 months. Maddox orchestrates it with an offensive line that includes Pro Bowler Alan Faneca and two dynamite receivers with Hines Ward along with Plexico Burris, who you are going to watch closely today.
He'll be matched up on 21, bottom of the screen, Chris McAllister.
It's third down and 20, back at the 10. And from the gun, they got Maddox. For Matu Ma'afala is blocking. That's intercepted and picked off on the play by Baltimore. And diving in with a touchdown, a flag is down. Gary Baxter caught it. A flag is down.
It's going to be roughing the passer, I think, on Baltimore.
It is, you're right. So wipe the interception away.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. From the 98 of the defense, contact with the middle quarterback. 15-yard penalty, and a first down.
That's Anthony Weaver, who has come now two consecutive plays into the face of Tommy Maddox.
We tipped the ball on the play before, and coming around on the game, 98. That's a pretty ticky-tack foul right there. The penalty comes right there when he hits Tommy Maddox in the head. If you get anywhere near the quarterback's head, they're going to call that.
25-yard line, first and 10. The pitch out to zero A. Nice hole in the middle, and he finally is brought down by Ed Hartwell at about the 32-yard line. It's a gain on the play of 8. Now the Baltimore defense, 19th rated in the NFL. Dalis Thomas leads the defensive line in the linebacking corps. Peter Boulware, the Pro Bowler, for a third consecutive year. In the secondary, Chris McAllister, as we've talked about, will have his hands full today with Plexico Burris. McAllister, 4 years out of Arizona. Second down, long two outside the 32. Hines Ward, the top of your screen, on the move. And the zero in. In the block from Simmons, which opens up the hole, and a first down run. Charging up to the 48-yard line, brought down by Anthony Mitchell, picks up 16 and moves the chains. Again, Bettis not playing today because of a bad knee.
Watching the bottom of the screen, you're going to see the blocking that was off between Burris and McAllister. Here's McAllister right here, last second coming in there. He gets so caught up with the wide receiver, Plexico Burris, his run support is late, and that gets zero away the last 5 yards.
It is a first down at the 48. This is a zero away again. He's wrapped up and from the end after a gain of 2. They had Riddick Parker in there, combining on the stop. And also Boulware. Heads up. Gain of 2, second down and 8. Zero away. And taking the place of Bettis this afternoon.
You know, if I'm Bill Cowher right now, I'm a little concerned sort of with the way my team started this game mentally. You know, that's one of the reasons you're seeing them running the ball so much. This is out of their character of late. Normally it's been a two-minute offense and chunking it. They're running it right now, I think, to get more of a rhythm.
Matalala falling in the backfield, and he goes outside, Maddox does, and second down and eight, and finds Plexico Burris, who's held on to by Ed Reed. It's a first down, gain of 13 to the Baltimore 37.
Hey, you want to talk about formations, getting the matchups you want? That formation got them the perfect matchup. The rookie Ed Reed, number 20, you know, good interceptor, great hitter, very, very good safety. But if you can get Plexico Burris against Reed, that says go downfield. Don't go short. Go deep. That's a mismatch.
First and 10 for Abatama falling in the backfield. 37-yard line of Baltimore. And he dumps it outside. Dan Kreider bobbled it. The fullback reels it in. Brought down by Baxter. Close to a first down. And close to the 27-yard line of Baltimore. Kreider catches just his 16th reception of the season.
Hey, you know, when you've got a receiver like Plexico Burris that people are worried about, you drive him off, then you bring the fullback underneath. Look at the area that clears out for Kreider coming out of the fullback spot because of Plexico Burris and his talents. Defenses are worried about Burris. They forget all about Kreider coming into the flat. That's a gimme 10, 12 yards.
Couple tight ends, including Matt Cushing. Eighth play of the drive, Zeroway back in. From the 27 of Baltimore. Amos Zeroway. Boy, he's wrapped up and brought down by Ed Hartwell along with Peter Bulware. It's a loss of two on the play. And in the absence of the injured Ray Lewis, it's been Ed Hartwell, Randy Cross, who has stepped up and filled the void.
Well, it's been one of those questions that are answered for Brian Billick. You know, who else do I have on defense? And it took losing a Ray Lewis for Hartwell really to step up. And he played well when he was with Lewis before. But once Ray Lewis went down, Ed Hartwell really became sort of that heartbeat at linebacker for the Baltimore Ravens defense that Lewis was before he left.
Second and 12, Zeroway and Kreider in the backfield from the Baltimore 28. Maddox with time, flings a pass downfield, incomplete for his tight end, Jeremy Tooman. It'll be third and 12.
One thing that's impressive to me about the Baltimore defense, for all the people they've lost, for the Ray Lewis's, and then every free agent you can think of, every star player besides Peter Bulware you can think of from the Super Bowl teams, they've still got the attitude. And when you sit down and you talk to a Chris McAllister, he says that's the way they're expected to play. It's been there that way for the 4 years that McAllister has been there. It's an expectation I think Ray Lewis and Brian Billick bring to this defense.
Kreider and Fuamatuma'a Fala in the backfield, third and 12 from the 28. Maddox again, plenty of time. Now they come at him with Weaver from the backside. And it's incomplete, looking again for the fullback, Kreider. And
got a flag at about the right 10-yard line.
Exactly.
A little illegal contact down the field, I think.
Illegal contact. Number 21 defense. 5-yard penalty. And a first down.
It's the second time on third down today that a penalty has bailed out the Steelers.
And that's that matchup we told you about, Chris McAllister and Plexico Burris. The other thing a big physical receiver brings is mistakes. And Chris McAllister is a fine defensive back. If there's one thing on the do not do list and don't have to do list, I would put grab. You do not have to grab. You're talented enough. Don't be intimidated. Stay with him.
Zero in the backfield. First and 10 from the 23. Good block by Gandy. And Maddox going deep. He's got Hines Ward who dives in for a Steeler touchdown. A 23-yard strike for Maddox.
Watch the ball, watch the pylon, he's being pushed. Ball inside the pylon, that is a touchdown.
Pylon is part of the end zone.
Right, around the world. I love that term.
Yeah, exactly.
The pylon's the extension of the goal line that goes all the way around the world. I gotta see that one.
Jeff Reed with the extra point. And let's go back to the Deshae Townsend interception in the end zone of Blake. And the call back, Baltimore interception.
The Anthony Weaver hit to Maddox's head, set that up. And good game planning, and Plexico Burris set up Hines Ward here.
Yes, is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 37. IBM, taking business to the next level with e-business on demand. And by Saturn, makers of the View, redesigned L-Series, and the all-new Ion.
It's the beautiful PP&G ice skating rink and Christmas tree here in downtown Pittsburgh. A very festive scene. And the ensuing kickoff by the Steelers after the 23-yard touchdown pass. Taylor on the fly from the 18 and brought down by Hope. A rookie out of Florida State for the Steelers. Hines Ward with a touchdown reception, his 12th of the year. It's the Steelers by 7.
Roll over your 401.
Green course.
Give the judge.
Steelers cash in on the Deshaun Townsend interception in the end zone. Marching the other way, a touchdown pass to Hines Ward.
Hey, how many other former college quarterbacks can say they've got 100 and some odd catches in one season?
From the 39, it's first and 10. Baltimore's second possession. Fake to Lewis, who blocks Hampton. A pass outside for Travis Taylor, their star wide receiver with all the injuries. Gain of 12 to the 49-yard line of the Steelers.
Well, here's Hines Ward right here. Here is McAllister right here. Now watch this matchup, and you tell me if Hines Ward doesn't get away with a little club move. Look at that club move behind the back of McAllister. That creates a separation in the matchup, and that creates a separation in the room that sets up that touchdown. So we told you to watch McAllister early, and he's played a big part in both Steeler drives.
Lewis in the backfield, first and 10 from the 49. Blake going to the side, looking for Hines. What a catch by the former Grambling quarterback. Dances now with Alexander. Hines steps it inside the 10 to the 6-yard line. A gain of 43 yards. A different looking version of maybe Plexico Burris they've got now in Baltimore in this kid Hines.
Well, for Baltimore, it's been good news, bad news. The bad news is you've had a lot of injuries at wide receiver. The good news is if you hadn't, you'd never know the former Grambling quarterback number 81 Hines could do the things he did. For Doug Williams, he kind of got in his doghouse last year at Grambling. Williams put him at wide receiver, goes in the game and catches 12 passes.
First and goal from the 6. They've got Lewis in the backfield. He gets the call, the Ricard block, and he crunches his way down to the 1 and fumbles the ball. It's in the end zone and recovered out of it. They say touchdown. They give him a touchdown.
No. Did he get it in the end zone?
Exactly.
There's got to
right.
be a replay.
Ricard, the fullback, jumped at it, but I thought he was sliding out of bounds with
Bill
the ball.
Bill Cowher has got to throw his replay, his challenge flag here.
Recovering the ball. Control the ball inbounds before he touched out of bounds. Touchdown.
Controlled the ball inbounds before he hit out of bounds. That's a red challenge flag waiting to happen right there. And Bill Cowher's got it out and he's getting ready to chuck it. Nice job by Alexander stuffing him. And Jamal Lewis trying to put the ball over the goal line. Loses the ball on Flowers' leg. Does he have control on the first or second bounce? And Bill Cowher just threw the flag out to challenge that play.
Bill Cowher took his time because his assistant's upstairs, again, watching the replay and telling him in his wireless headset, and he was pausing to make sure they were certain it was reviewable, in their mind, challengeable.
Pittsburgh has challenged the ruling on the field, but the player possessed the ball before touching it out of bounds.
Lewis has fumbled 8 times this year. None of those previous 8 have been recovered by his own team. So
one more time, let's take a look at this. Watch the ball get to the end. Comes out off of Flowers' leg, trying to stretch it for the score. Now watch the recovery. Control before it goes out. Does he have it? I think he's still juggling it when that ball gets...
Randy,
ball,
watch
the control. Does he have it? But he's out of bounds when he has it.
Exactly.
I think that's going to be a touchback.
It was not under control. Now, the other thing is, too, was the guy down before he even fumbled the ball?
It's control. That's what... Now, see, it's both things are open now that they're reviewing it.
Was he down and had his knee hit?
Watch Alexander's body.
You'd have to go back. It was very close even there.
Yeah.
No, you know what? He falls on the leg, so his knee does not hit the ground.
He's not on the ground. He's
right.
on
He's on the leg.
Ball is out. That's a fumble. That's a fumble, and I believe it's going to be a touchback because I don't see total control. Remember, indisputable visual evidence.
They have already ruled a touchdown, so they've got to make sure that...
Right, it's got to be indisputable.
Right, indisputable. So Ron Winter will take a look at the replays that will be given to him from up here in the press box, and let's go down to the sideline of Beasley Reese.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. That happened about 12, 15 yards away from where I'm standing, and from my angle, it looked like he did grab it and corral it. It is very quick. He was right on the edge, but from my angle, it looks like he had it, and it is a touchdown. Back to you.
We can see here it is indeed a fumble because his knee lands on another player's leg. So it did not hit the ground. Now this is a fumble.
It's been ruled a touchdown. And if it's overturned and he sees when Mr. Winter is there looking in the hood, sees that there's enough evidence that says that isn't a touchdown to overrule the call on the field, it would be a touchback. It would be Pittsburgh ball on the 20-yard line going the other way. I'm not sure if it's indisputable, though.
After review, the player recovering the ball possesses the ball inbounds and maintains control of the ball throughout the process before he touches out of bounds. The ruling on the field stands, the player's a touchdown. Pittsburgh is charged with a timeout.
A heads-up play by Ricard. Does he have it and control it? Got it? Out. That's a bang-bang. That's like the play at first base. It was not only bang-bang under the hood, it was bang-bang when it happened, and we're ruling here in Baltimore that it was bang-bang the right way for Baltimore.
Baltimore's headed now two times first and goal. They throw an interception the first time, and they lose it. They fumble at that time, but Ricard jumps on the ball.
Yeah. Sure.
And we're tied.
Are you positive? Yeah.
I am positive.
On CBS is sponsored by Circuit City. We know how you feel, that's why we're here. Circuit City, we're with you. And by Hummer. Check out the new H2 at Hummer.com. Hummer, like nothing else.
Antoine Randall. We apologize for audio problems. And this is Hank Poteet on the ensuing kickoff after the Baltimore touchdown. And he's brought down by Scott, 22-yard gain. And he is up to the 35-yard line. Not having Bettis in there affect Pittsburgh's offense today.
I think without Bettis, this offense over the last 2 years has been more versatile. They've learned to do very well without him.
35-yard line after the Baltimore kickoff. First and 10, Amos Haraway. Nice block by Hines Ward. And a hold. The flag is down. In of 15 yards will probably be wiped away.
I think it's going to be against Big Gandy. Big Wayne Gandy, number 72. We're going to get Cornell Brown.
There are two fouls on the play. Holding. Number 86 offense. That penalty will be assessed from the previous spot. Holding. Number 84 offense. That penalty is declined. Repeat. First down.
Well, we told you today that Baltimore has to have a lot of things fall right. Number one, they've got to win.
And then this. And of all of them, the unlikely one, and the one you say you got to be kidding, is Denver losing to Arizona. But, you know, if you're Brian Billick in your organization, you sell the fact that there's a chance, not of the odds of that chance happening.
So we're in the backfield, first and 20 from the 25. The block by Faneca, that sets up the screen pass to Zeroway, who is brought down by Bernard O'Harris. It's a gain of 9, he's up to the 33.
And for Pittsburgh, you know, although they've clinched, They'd like to win a game. They'd love to see Tennessee lose to Houston, so it would give them the home field, you know, in at least a playoff game or two with the number two seed. But I'm not sure if Bill Cowher and his football team wants home field. They'd be better off maybe playing all their games on the road. You know, last year we came here with CBS for the championship game. They laid an egg at home. They've laid other eggs at home in championship games. Why not go on the road and see if that works better?
For Matamata in the backfield, second down and 11. That whistles over the head of tight end Jeremy Tooman. And he was covered on the play by Harris. It'll be third down and 11. Now, Steelers sometimes, people feel, play better with a chip on their shoulder.
And, you know, and a lot of that's their defense and their mentality defensively, because we talked about their mentality offensively. It's a little different with Tommy Maddox, and it's kind of out of the Bill Cowher mold to be throwing the ball that much and to sort of chunk it around like a two-minute drill. But for the talent on this offense, that's the right thing for Mike Mularkey, the coordinator, to do. It's to throw all over the lot and try to get Plexico Burress in as good a matchup as you can get.
Maddox has thrown a touchdown pass today. Third and 11 from a 34. Across the middle, Maddox. Caught by Antoine Randall, the elusive rookie out of Indiana. Squirts his way up to the 48. Picks up 14 yards on third down and 11. Brought down on the play by Riddick Parker.
And, you know, that's something else that Tommy Maddox is going to love when it comes to playoff times, is having this weapon, Antoine Randall, as that third, fourth option in his offense. Talk about a guy that you want to get the ball with a little air around it. It's one of the great, you know, air guys right now in the league, this young guy at Indiana. You get him around people with some space, he can make everybody miss.
Zero in the backfield, first and 10, zero in the call. Goes by Brown, breaks a tackle for Mitchell, and he's chased by Baxter. Racing outside, Amos Zeroway to the 30-yard line of Baltimore. That was an impressive 22-yard gain.
And really, the impressive part started 5 yards down the field. You watch right about here on the field and in the defensive backfield or in the linebacker area for the Baltimore Ravens. That's a space. Watch that space. First contact by Brown. Next contact happens about 12, 15 yards down the field. It's kind of back he is, kind of like a Travis Henry. If you don't wrap him up immediately, you're going to lose him.
Good comparison. First and 10 outside the 30 for Matamata with a Kreider block. And Tooman tries to give a block, and he's wrestled out of bounds by Peter Bolwin. Flags all over the field. 7-yard gain as it stands right now. I think Bolwin was on the chalk when he whipped him down.
It's usually not the hit, it's that whipping them down,
yes.
It's that intent out of bounds that'll get you that flag.
Personal foul. Unnecessary ruckus. Number 58 of the defense. Analyze half the distance to the goal. Got a first down.
And you talked earlier about Jerome Bettis. And, you know, what does he mean to this offense? Well, Fu Maafala, and you can see Bowler whips him out of bounds kind of unnecessarily wide there. Maafala is a younger version of Jerome Bettis, the same kind of a player as Jerome Bettis, but he runs a screen pass, I think, as good as any back in this league.
At the 11, first and 10. Fu in the backfield, and Ramata Maafala gets the call, and he was tripped up by Kelly Craig, number 97, on his stomach. Lunge and grabbed him, gain of two, second down.
It's somewhere you're not surprised to see Kelly Craig end up. Kelly Craig, number 97, in the middle. I mean, they list this guy at, what, 6 foot, 6'1"? He is begging. He's got about 5'10". You can eat lunch off the top of his head, but I got to tell you what, just a heart guy out of Oklahoma, played for Rex Ryan when he was there at the University of Oklahoma. He's the kind of guy every single winning team has got to have.
Zeroway inside the 10, second down and 8, seventh play of the drive, Maddox to Zeroway. And nice read outside by the Pro Bowler, Peter Bowler. Loss on the play of a yard. Bring him back to about the 16.
And when I say that about a guy like Kelly Craig, you know, what I'm referring to is, you know, watch this nose guard right here rushing against Harding's, the center, 64. You got to have the guys that have the attitude, that have the want to. He's not a great pass rusher. He's an excellent run defender who is going to get some scraps inside, is going to make things for Peter Bowler and the other linebackers that line up behind him.
His whole career has been scraps. Fuamata Maafala in the backfield, third and 14.
Watch the jump ball to Plexico Burress.
And Maddox fires a pass, which is caught at about the 6-yard line. Tackle made by Reed and Trapp, and the grab is made by Terrence Mathis. His 23rd reception of the season. A touchdown pass by Pittsburgh, a fumble recovery in the end zone by Baltimore. We're tied at 7 at the end of 1. You're watching the NFL on CBS. We begin the second quarter here in Pittsburgh with Randy Cross and Beasley Reese, Kevin Harlan. It's 4th down and 3, and so Pittsburgh has opted for a field goal try by young Jeff Reed. He was signed in mid-November. This is a 23-yard try, taking the place of the ineffective Todd Peterson. And with the Maddox hold, Pittsburgh has their second lead today.
Hey, no, Kevin, not everybody on this team knew who the heck this guy was. In fact, when Cowher asked for the first vote for a game ball after his first game he won, the guys voted the kicker.
The kicker.
The kicker.
Number 3.
Hey, it's me, Peter. You knew that. Look, I don't know how to say this, but, you know, I need to move on. I mean, you have been great, really. I just need to be on my own for a while. Well, thanks for everything, and guess this is goodbye, huh?
Get a new lease on life with the Acura TL Type S. See your Acura dealer for details.
Just because a toothbrush is electric doesn't mean it works like a Sonicare. It has patented Sonic technology. Whiter, healthier teeth in 28 days, guaranteed. Ask your dental professional about Sonicare.
Introducing Cause for Celebration, a food container that resists tomato stains. Get the revolutionary stain shield only from Rubbermaid.
Welcome back to the Shrine Auditorium. Oh, no, look at these two.
Go online and cast your vote for the postseason awards. Make your pick for MVP, coach, and rookie of the year at cbs.sportsline.com or on AOL, keyword, CBS Sportsline. Chester Taylor from the 7-yard line for the Baltimore Ravens. And brought down nicely on the play by reserve linebacker Clark Higgins. That is a 17-yard return to the sideline in Beasley Reese.
All right, thanks, Kevin. I'm with one of the best running backs in the history of this league, Jerome Bettis. The bus is parked right now. How does the knee feel? I know you couldn't practice during the week.
The knee, it recovered a little slower this week because we had a short week with the Monday night game and all. But it feels a lot better now, and just looking forward to next week.
Now, you will play in a playoff game if it's next week.
Oh, no doubt about it.
Nothing can stop the bus.
There's nothing that's going to stop the bus.
Now, what do you anticipate your practice schedule will be next week?
Well, next week I'll be fine. I'll go out and won't have a problem. But, you know, the benefit I have is having Amos there away and just having him there helps me out so much.
All right, thank you, Bus. Good luck with your recovery, buddy. All right, Kevin.
Thank you, Beasley. And that's the second sack today by Pittsburgh, turned in by Rodney Bailey, 2 years out of Ohio State.
Bailey comes right up the heart and basically doesn't even get touched. The Baltimore Ravens opened up as an offensive line, and one of the things they opened up was a clear path to their quarterback. Nobody even blocked Rodney Bailey.
He's got 5 sacks. Who is this guy?
Quietly.
Yes, quietly. Exactly.
That's the kind of guy up front you have to have if you're going to have a number one defense. The guys nobody knows about to get the stats.
What a good pick by the Steelers. 2nd down and 20. And Blake dumps it off to Lewis. He's got a block from Flynn, but then you can see from behind, Aaron Smith coming through. Gain of 5 on the play. Kendrell Bell there as well. Let's go to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, Kevin, you know how critical this game is. Miami and New England, and the Dolphins are on the board first. It's Ricky Williams from 8 yards out. 7-0 Miami. Let's go back to you.
Ricky Williams now has 9 100-yard rushing games this year. You can see what happens. They can clinch the East with the win today. And the other scenarios right on down the list. A lot has to happen for Miami. 3rd down and 15. At the 18-yard line. And Blake throws his receiver slips. They're going from Ron Johnson. Incomplete pass.
Yeah, Kevin, we saw the
make it win, excuse me.
We saw the 2 big games yesterday. How important was running the ball there? We saw Ricky Williams do what he's doing right now. How important is running the ball there? So Beasley was talking just a little while ago to the bus, Jerome Bettis. How important in a bad weather game in the playoffs is having a pounded out back like Jerome Bettis? He'll be invaluable if he truly can be 100% next week.
Zestido will punt inside the eight. And Antoine Randall waving it off. He'll let it drop. And Baltimore will down it at about the 46-yard line. Down by Ray Perriman. 36-yard punt. A look at Ray Bettis. Jerome Bettis, rather. Trying to stay warm.
CBS is sponsored by Acura and the 260-horsepower TL Type S. Coors Light, the official beer sponsor of the NFL. Cold, down, easy. And by Motorola, bringing intelligence everywhere. Hello, Moto.
It's on the incline coming from Mount Washington overlooking downtown Pittsburgh. Steelers have a touchdown pass. Baltimore. First and 10. Here's Antoine Randall trying to throw down field. And chased by Craig from behind and brought down at the 47-yard line. And a gain of one. Well, the Steelers today and Bill Cowher with the win and a loss by Tennessee get that coveted first-round bye.
Hey, you look at teams like the best example might be the team across the field. The Baltimore Ravens, when they won their Super Bowl a couple of years ago, they didn't have a bye. You know, they won a home playoff game. Then they went to Tennessee, to Oakland, and to the Super Bowl and won it.
Second down, short nine. And Romatu Ma'afala up to the 50-yard line on a gain of two. And then brought down by the interior. Peter Boulware was there with the tackle.
The most important one here is to remember that Miami, though they lead the division, belongs over with still alive. Because you know, there are theoretical ways that Miami can end up not in the playoffs by a certain combination of wins. But everybody in the East that's playing today, except for Buffalo, has got a shot at that title.
Third and six from the 50. They got Maddox in the gun. And he flings it downfield incomplete. Flag is thrown. It was,
boy, was that late.
Plexico Burris in the sights of Maddox. Baxter was covering.
That was begging he shall receive late.
Number 28 defense. Penalizes the spot of the foul. And a first down.
And it's Plexico Burris, number 80, working against Baxter. Now here comes the beg. Plays over, 1,001, 1,002, 1,000 flag.
Yeah.
That was pretty late, and I didn't see anything there that you wouldn't call from Baxter, just good defense and kind of incidental contact, but what you did see was a real good beg by Plexico Burris.
That's the third time today on third down. Pittsburgh's been bailed out with a penalty on Baltimore. First and 10 handoff to Amos Zeroway. Cut the corner, then cracked into by Ed Hartwell. Is down after a gain of five to about the 29. Let's go to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, Kevin, Randy, Pittsburgh wins and the Texans upset the Titans. Pittsburgh gets a first round bye. Texans going for the tying field goal, second quarter. Chris Brown's kick is blocked by rookie Tank Williams and the Titans hold on to a 3-0 lead in Tennessee's return to the Houston area. Let's go back to you.
All right, Jim, thank you. The Titans clinch first round bye with the win. Or a tie or Miami and Pittsburgh losses. Second down, long five. Zero away. And he's hit by Hartwell and brought down at the 28. Gain of a yard. Let's go back to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, guys, for the second time in this game, Ricky Williams has found the end zone for Miami. Look at this move at the line of scrimmage. Shakes free, goes to the outside, and Williams with his 16th rushing touchdown of the season, a Miami record in 1 year. Let's go back to Kevin and Randy.
Remember that streak where New England was giving up 200 and something yards rushing, it seemed, every week? Looks like it's back.
Third and five from the 28. And Maddox throws a pass, good for a first down. It's caught by Hines Ward, who already has a touchdown reception today. A gain of eight to the Baltimore 20. Back to what Jim Nance was talking about, the Patriots, they clinched the AFC East with a win and a Jets loss. And they're still alive for the wild card berth with the win or tie, and of course the all-important help.
Remember this time last year, New England had it, whatever it is. Well, they don't have it.
The chemistry thing.
Even if they make the playoffs, it has eluded them. Right now, most of it lives in Tennessee with McNair and the Titans.
Inside the 20, first and 10, the fake is early. It's Plexico Burris going up against Baxter, and it's incomplete in the end zone. Little jump ball for Plex.
Altitude issue.
Yes.
Altitude issue. Because in this matchup, when you're looking at Plexico Burris going against Baxter, this pass has got to be high, and it's got to be in the emblem, the NFL emblem in that end zone on that right side. You lob it up high, and it lands in the middle of the emblem, and if it does, it's a touchdown. It lands on the left shoulder pad of Baxter, and that's why it's not, and no one knew that better than Tommy Maddox.
He's got one catch. They've thrown to him four times. Second down and 10, speaking of Burris, that is. Inside the 20. And Maddox again. Rifles a pass. Great catch made. Tight end Tooman. He is to the 7. Make at the 8-yard line. He picks up 12 on the play. He was working on safety Ed Reed. It's first and goal Steelers.
It's really something that that Tommy Maddox has added to this offense. And it's something that, frankly, Cordell Stewart did not do well. And that spread the ball around. Because Tommy Maddox so far today, if you went ahead and say, what's the theme? The theme is out of those 9 completions, it's spreading the ball around to as many receivers as possible with those 9 completions.
First and goal at the 8. Zeroway in the backfield. Crider, the fullback, is on the move. Zeroway the call, wrapped up by Thomas. No gain on the play. At Bayless Thomas came streaming through, second down and goal.
That's been the theme for the Baltimore Ravens, is when they play teams that they can really stand with and go with. There's a Dallas Thomas 96 right there. Just really isn't blocked and crashes in from the backside. And that's what the new defensive end will do in this league. The old defensive end wouldn't quite get there. The Strahans, the Taylors, the top-notch guys will make that play just like a Dallas Thomas just made.
Cushing becomes the second tight end, second and goal at the 9. 9th play of the drive. Zeroway with the block, and they throw it out to Kreider, who is upended on the side by Baxter at about the 6-yard line, and a gain of 3. Third and goal.
It's really now, when you're looking at the Pittsburgh Steelers offense, what's the difference from last year and the year before and this year? The difference is you've got to concentrate on Burris, but you can't lose focus on Ward, on Tooman, on Kreider, on Zeroway, on Randall L. They've got so many products and so many weapons, and Maddox doesn't mind spreading it to all of them.
Third and goal at the 6. Watch for Burris. Bottom of your screen. Here comes Maddox. And they come streaming in. Grabbed by the rookie Chad Williams, and he throws it away, and a flag is down.
Face mask.
Williams got him. 6th round pick out of Southern Miss. On 3rd down again, 4th time that Pittsburgh has been bailed out on Baltimore penalties on Pittsburgh 3rd downs.
Personal foul. Grasping the face mask. On the 49 defense. And lies half the distance to the goal. Got a first down.
And on the previous touchdown drive by Pittsburgh, they blew 3rd and 12 and 3rd and 20. And Maddox knows from the get-go. Look at that. He felt the face mask. He knows the flag. He's peeking out of his ear hole because of the face mask, but he's signaling the first down.
A lot of penalties on Baltimore already. Zeroway in the backfield, first and goal at the 3. Zeroway to about the 2, grabbed by Hartwell. In the first meeting with these two teams, Baltimore had 13 penalties back in late October. They're on that same track today.
Hey, when you're standing in a game you know is going to be kind of a toe-to-toe contest, and physically, you know, Brian Billick's made the comment this week that he thinks Pittsburgh is the most talented team in the NFL. Physically, which, you know, frankly, is kind of a knock on Bill Cowher and his coaching staff in an obtuse way, but, you know, you can't give the other team this many opportunities because you're guaranteed to lose if you do.
Zeroway in the backfield, second goal at the 1. Kreider with the block, and he picks up maybe a half yard, and that's it. Another pulling lineman, which was Alan Faneca, who came from his left guard to lead the way.
Who happens to be one of the best pulling linemen that's played in this league in the last couple of years. Had a great game last week against Tampa Bay and Warren Sapp. In fact, if Sapp hadn't have rolled up on Tommy Maddox's ankle, we might not have known that Warren Sapp, number 99, was even in that game Monday night.
Three tight ends, pushing Allred and Tooman. Third and goal at the one. Zero in the backfield. 12th play of the drive. He'll walk in for a touchdown. And the Steelers extend their lead.
This is called an O block. And really for a lot of reasons in this case. But watch Harding's block back. Blocked down by Simmons and around by Faneca. Why do you call it an O? Well, that's really what it was called a long time ago, but in this case, it's O, because that was wide open. Oh!
There's a zero.
Zero wins. Amos.
Three tacks on another. 6:48 to play in the first half. Amos Zeroway, third rushing touchdown. And the Steelers on top of Baltimore. Maddox leads him on another touchdown drive. He has thrown a touchdown pass. And on that drive, some passing and a new Steelers single season passing record. The ensuing kickoff, Chester Taylor at about the 14-yard line for Baltimore. Oh, good block by Sam Gash. And the kicker, Reed, can't get him. Now to Shea Townsend, tries to push him out of bounds. And gets a little bit of help on that play by Lee Mays, reserve wide receiver. So all that good that Pittsburgh does on that drive wiped out on a 54-yard kickoff return.
Was that some terrible tackling?
Horrible.
I expected the kicker to the rest of them.
Sponsored by MasterCard. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. And by Staples. Get back time. Go to Staples.
Log on to NFL.com. Get the latest on the playoff picture. Plus, see next week's playoff schedule first only at NFL.com or on AOL. Enter keyword NFL.com.
The interesting one to me that a lot of fans will vote on and sports writers and people around this league is MVP. Is it best numbers or most valuable player to his football team? Most times, it's best numbers that wins that award.
First and 10, 32-yard line. Jamal Lewis in the backfield for Jeff Blake. And Lewis down the gut, spun around, taken down by Mike Jones. Gain of about two, second down and eight at the 30.
That's a nice job on that last kickoff return, though, by Baltimore. Watch the crease that develops right behind this wedge. Follow the wedge, see the crease. Be the ball. Taylor's being the ball. The kicker's back to being the kicker. Unless you can tackle, nobody's going to remember your name. And Shea Townsend puts a whiff on him.
Second down and eight from the 30. Lewis again. And getting a nice block from Jonathan Ogden, which springs him free inside the 10-yard line. He's down at the 5. And a 25-yard gallop by Jamal Lewis. Over 1,200 yards on the ground this year.
Watch Jeff Blake, the quarterback. Normally I'd say watch the blocking, but look at the nice job by Blake to get Lewis that ball. Sprinting hard out to get him that ball. Defense looked like they were thinking that was a play action fake. He had to go so far to get the halfback the ball. That in itself stretched the defense.
Chester Taylor and Ricard are in the game. First and goal at the 6. Ricard gets the call and bulldozes his way in for a touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown, his second rushing touchdown of the season.
Kevin, Baltimore didn't get the memo that Pittsburgh's a better team. Brian Billick has sold this team on a lot of things during the 2002 season, most of which it's you can hang with anybody. Pittsburgh is very talented. Pittsburgh looks a little arrogant. And Baltimore right now is hanging right with them and being a very physical football team. Excellent job up front by the line and Ricard.
Ricard has 2 touchdowns today. That extra point by Stover. 3 plays, 32 yards, a 54-yard kickoff return by Taylor. Sets up Ricard, 6-yard touchdown run.
The secret weapon.
That's our score. Baltimore just scored. Ricard goes in from 6 yards away. Now he plays in the kickoff team. Little chip shot here. And Antoine Randall inside the 20. And brought down by wide receiver Ron Johnson, 11-yard return. They'll spot him at the 28-yard line. Well, coming up in the next halftime report, it'll be busy and it will be good. Jim, Dan, Dion, and Boomer have all the scores and highlights, plus the latest on the playoff picture. We'll also have New Orleans running back Deuce Staley. It's coming up in the next halftime report.
Philadelphia Eagles, I believe.
Yes, I'm sorry. It said New Orleans on my copy.
Hey, you know, if you're a defensive player, you know what your number one goal is for the Baltimore Ravens? Third down. Stop making dumb mistakes on third down and keeping Pittsburgh on the field.
First and 10 from the 28. Go outside, incomplete, looking for Ward. Now, I think it is Deuce. There's a Deuce McAllister, who plays for New Orleans, but the copy here
but
says...
But he's a little busy today.
Well, he is a little busy. All right, so I guess fire whoever gave you that New Orleans thing.
But, you know, I mentioned that about third down four times today. This Baltimore defense has had Tommy Maddox and this offense in a bad situation on third down, third and 12, third and 20, third and 10, third and 8, and let them up with dumb penalties.
28-yard line, second down and 10, 0A. Cornell Brown, among others, were right there. No gain on the play, third and 10.
That's the whole inside of that defense,
yeah.
Kevin. I mean, Kelly Gregg and Hartwell and... You know, Brown and the whole side of that Baltimore Ravens unit. And you see Kelly Gregg, he doesn't run off the field. Butter Lee is his kind of nickname he got from Tony Siragusa last year. And when your legs are that short, you just sort of move them across the field. You don't run that fast because the knees don't bend.
Third down and 10. Full Montemayor follow in the backfield. Maddox to Fu. Nice block by Fanica. Hartwell brings him down, but shy of first down. They had to get up to the 38. He gets as far as the 34. And a rare punting situation now coming up for the Steelers. After that gain of six, and Maddox has to leave the field with nothing to show.
And for Baltimore, you were smart on third down, and you stopped one of the plays coming into this game. You really had checked off on your list to say, we've got to stop Ma'afala on a screen pass on third down. That was an excellent job by the defense of swarming to the Pittsburgh runner.
Tom Ruin, the punt, the ex-Denver Bronco. Lamont Brightfield back at the 25-yard line for Baltimore. There's a nice block on the play by Shannon Taylor and a 3-yard return after a 41-yard punt. And the tackle made by Marco Battaglia. Wednesday, January 8th on CBS Star Search, helped discover the likes of Ray Romano and Alanis Morissette. Who will be next? The search is on. It's the premiere of an all-new Star Search, live Wednesday, January 8th at 8, 7 Central on CBS, America's most watched network. Little Pittsburgh dominance in possession time.
As usual, Baltimore is only really interested in the scoreboard, not the stats. And they're only down by three.
28-yard line, first and 10 after the Pittsburgh punt. Lewis in the backfield on the call, gets by Bell, then he's upended by Brent Alexander. After a gain of 9, he's up to the 37-yard line.
Jamal Lewis, you know, he went to school with Travis Henry at the University of Tennessee, and they both remind me of the same kind of guy. And you know, Jamal Lewis with 51 yards rushing is... He and Travis Henry are kind of muscles with a helmet and feet attached. And when you hit him, the first guy's got to grab something. I don't care if it's pants or jersey or leg, and you need help to get him down. One guy does not tackle these runners.
37, second down and one. Fake to Ricard, the pitch out to Lewis, chased by Joey Porter, and around the side, finally Porter brings him down. But not after he scampers for a first down, and he is at about the 43 on a 20-yard burst.
You know, imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, they say. And here, watch Jamal Lewis. And this is something that Denver did a lot with Terrell Davis. What they do, they fake strong, and then they pitch it weak, kind of naked. All you really have out there is a block by your wide receiver. You're counting on overreaction by the defense, and Baltimore got it.
First and 10. Taylor. Mike Jones brings him down in the middle after a gain of 3 to the 40-yard line.
Pretty confident, kind of methodical drive right now for Baltimore, isn't it, Kevin?
Yes, nothing to tight end Todd Heap so far.
Well, you know, you look to the,
except for the first play of the game, of course.
Give defensive coordinator Tim Lewis some credit for Pittsburgh. You know, he got burned on that first play, and since that first play, he has been swarming and doubling number 86 wherever he goes. There's Tim Lewis right there in the white shirt.
40-yard line, second down and seven. And this is Chester Taylor again, slithering his way by one defender after another. Lee Flowers finally gets him after a gain of five to the 35.
Slithering. You're some wordsmith, aren't you? Well, when you slither, when you get hit that hard, what happened? You get splattered?
Try saying that fast a couple times.
Slither, splatter, and stop.
We've reached the two-minute warning here at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. Dion and Boomer, running back Deuce Staley of the Eagles. Highlights of the first half all over the country, plus the latest in the playoff picture. And still halftime coming up.
You know, Dion was all over old Marty Schottenheimer today on the pregame show, but you know, the whole AFC West seemed to claim him, and along with Bill Cowher. He left Cowher off his ire list this morning.
They claimed him. Third and two, 35. Lewis in the backfield, Heap in motion. Blake, second option. Incomplete. And looking across the middle, trying to go to tight end Terry Jones, who is a rookie from Alabama. First time they've thrown to him today.
And it's a big deal. I mean, Brian Billick does not have Todd Heap right now to go to. They brought Heap in motion and got him matched up on Lee Flowers, but the Pittsburgh defenders are not letting number 86 anywhere out of their sight.
They ran it seven consecutive times, shoved it right down Pittsburgh's throat. Then on third and two, they pass.
Are you offensive coordinator?
I'm just talking out loud here. I just don't know why they didn't run again. Zaxtonville's punt. Antoine Randall L. be back and down nicely at about the 7 yard line. This play by Ray Perriman again. Second time he has been involved in the special teams play. 28 yard punt. We'll see why CBS Monday is America's best night of television, starting with the King of Queens, followed by Yes Dear, Everybody Loves Raymond, and Still Standing. Then TV's number one news show, CSI Miami, and The Late Show with Dave Letterman. It's all Monday right here on CBS, America's most watched network.
Oh, that's all laughs and then high tech right there in the 10 o'clock slot. CSI Miami, you can watch all the high tech crime toys there are in the world.
And enjoy it. Steelers have two timeouts. First and 10, buck 45 to play here in the first half from the 7 yard line. Zero away. Oh, what a great block he got from the tight end, Newman, who opens up that game for seven up to the 14 yard line.
Hey, we talked about high tech toys on television shows. I mean, Tommy Maddox and this Pittsburgh offense, if there's one thing we haven't really kind of seen, and it's something that honestly the Baltimore Ravens wanted to take away from the Steelers, that was that kind of that quick start high tech toy offense that Tommy Maddox and the Steelers have used, and what got them to that big lead last Monday night against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Second down and three at the 14. Kreider in motion, Zeroway in the backfield. Zeroway the call, gets by Thomas. And tackled by Baxter, gain of five and a first down. Flag is down.
There's a hold against Adalis Thomas.
Number 64 offense. Penalized half the distance to the goal. Repeat second down.
Jeff Hardings came folding out from his center spot and tried to get a block on Adalis Thomas, who was at defensive end, and got a little bit of that jersey as Thomas was trying to get away from him to make that tackle.
Two timeouts for Pittsburgh, and Baltimore has all three. How would you utilize your timeouts both ways here?
As soon as this ball is down and whistle's blown, I call a timeout here. You've got three left and a minute to go. You can get some good field position out of this.
Second and 10 from the 7. Uh-oh, Zeroway slips, regains his footing, and then is smothered by Bulware and Bayless Thomas.
Great job by Tommy Maddox, handing off to a running back crawling at his knees.
Now Next Sunday, the playoff season takes off with the AFC wildcard game. Kickoff is scheduled for 1 o'clock. And remember, as always, the excitement begins with Jim, Dion, Dan, and Boomer and the NFL Today gang, beginning at noon Eastern. And the AFC playoff picture, four teams have made it, two slots remain, and see on the right-hand column the teams that are still vying, including Miami on the left.
And you got to emphasize the fact that Miami, though they're over there with division leaders, hasn't clinched a playoff spot, though right now they're looking pretty good up there in New England with Ricky Williams running the ball that well against the Patriots.
Although now it's Miami by a 14-7 count on New England. That was a Baltimore timeout, so they've got two, and Pittsburgh has two. Third down and 11. For Matumaafala is in the backfield. Four recently receivers deployed. And for Matumaafala, brought down immediately by James Trapp. And a timeout taken by Baltimore. They've got one left with 44 seconds on the clock.
That was excellent usage by Baltimore of their timeouts in this situation.
Baltimore's got to win going in, we know that, but then they need a lot of help from those five teams.
Well, they got some help yesterday. Kansas City losing to Oakland eliminated one team in the formula. And remember last week, Greg Williams told us of the year with the Houston Oilers when the Steelers needed six teams to lose on Sunday and a team to lose on Monday night. So it's not likely this formula falls in place for Baltimore, but it's that sliver of hope that Brian Billick and this extremely young football team have clung to all week long.
By the way, Denver and San Diego play late games this afternoon, so even if Baltimore does win, they will not know their fate.
There's Tom Ruin, former Denver Broncos. At least one Denver Bronco is guaranteed a playoff spot.
That's right. Oh, man. Ruin's had a couple blocked this season. Lamont Breifel back at about midfield for the Ravens. Looks like the block is on, too. And Ed Reed, who has blocked the punt already this year, came a little bit late. Breifel bobbles it, reels it in. It's by Poteet. And brought down by Alexander. 6-yard return after a 50-yard punt.
Remember the moonshots that Jeff Blake loves to throw. When you play a team quarterbacked by Jeff Blake, and you're a defensive coach, and you're a defensive back, especially a corner, you had better be aware from what the angle that the ball is going to drop out of. He can throw the high, long ball that will drop right over your head.
Dime package is in. Six defensive backs have come in for Pittsburgh. Blake's numbers right there. That interception, by the way, was thrown in the end zone on a goal-to-go situation early in the game. And Blake first and 10. Line it up, goes short this time. It's caught by Ricard, grabbed by Townsend and Flowers and Porter and Poteet. And picks up about 7-8 yards, and he's down to the Steeler 44.
Blake's trying to get the timeout quick.
Steeler is down.
No, he's complaining about not getting that timeout quick enough. It's not the referee's responsibility to find the quarterback. It's the quarterback's responsibility is to find the referee to call that timeout.
Good point. Lee Flowers is down. And a timeout has been taken, but an injury timeout goes against what you've got already. And the Is it Baltimore's timeout or Pittsburgh's timeout? Because the injury timeout automatically knocks the timeout off your side. And they announced a Baltimore timeout. But let's first of all watch this Flowers injury. And he's up.
He just kind of gets mushed by the pile.
Baltimore called the timeout.
It's officially being awarded to Baltimore.
Yep.
I guess if you award these things.
If that is an award, yes. So they've burned everything now. Pittsburgh's got two left.
Because of an injury, with less than a minute, the team with the injury is charged with a timeout. Pittsburgh is charged with their second timeout. Correction, third timeout. Baltimore has one timeout remaining.
Okay, well, Baltimore has one and Pittsburgh has one. That was not Pittsburgh's third.
They snatched that right off the award stand.
Well, yeah, we were just told from the officials upstairs that it was a Baltimore timeout. Nonetheless,
Netanyahu.
Second and three. 16 seconds to play in the half. Blake hit by Gildan, fumble on the play, and it's loose back at the 44.
That's gonna be Pittsburgh ball.
And the Steelers have it on the second Baltimore turnover today. And Jason Gildan offers a fine defensive play. 9 seconds remain in the half.
Jason Gildan is a kind of pass rusher. If you're an offensive lineman, you know just what you're getting. You're getting some strength, but a lot of speed. Working against Ethan Brooks. Good hand usage. Bad lean by Brooks. Head and body up over his feet. He gets pulled forward, and Gildan does a nice job of just pulling through and knocking this ball loose.
Actually, it may have slipped before he even got there. Clark Hagans picked it up.
Looked like that left hand was coming in there, grabbing at Blake, and contributed to that ball coming loose.
They need 10 to 15 yards to get a field goal attempt away, and now he's just 2.5 away from the all-time Steeler record of LC Greenwood's 73.5. All right, so at the 46, first and 10, 9 seconds to play in the half after the Baltimore turnover. Mannix winding and throwing short, cuts a go Burris at the 25 and catches out of bounds at the 25. The reception is good. It's a gain of 21 yards. 4 seconds remain, and they just got in field goal range.
Absolutely. This is a 6-point turnaround if they can convert this field goal.
That was a good catch by Burris. Possession and feet down, 2 feet.
Well, how can you miss a target that big?
It is a big target. 43-yard try here by Reed. He's already kicked one from 23 today. 9 of 11 at home. Movement on the line. Who'd you see?
That was Kimo von Olhoff of 67.
Number 67 offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
So it was a 43-yard try. Now back it up to the 38, 48-yard try.
Look at Bill Cowher. As a former special teams coach from the Cleveland Browns, little things like that will just torque him off. You're guaranteed to get a guy like him screaming and ranting at halftime when you're a guy like Olhoff and jumping off sides and putting even more pressure on your kicker.
48-yard try by Reed. His longest year, 50 yards. So Pittsburgh cashes in on the Baltimore fumble just before halftime.
And the second half, he is Steeler, is not the kicker. It's Kimo von Olhoffen who jumped off sides.
Reed now 10 of 12 in field goals here in Heinz Field this season.
And what a find and a field and a stadium that's been a graveyard for kickers the last couple of years.
The field in Beasley Reese.
All right, thanks a lot. I'm walking in with Coach Billy. Coach, it's unfortunate you had to give up the 3 points there. A little hectic right at the end.
Yeah, you know, it's when you first turn the ball over, and, you know, we just got to quit making mistakes, and the penalties, both real and imagined, we got to stop.
It's a great game for us, though, Coach. It's a lot of fun.
I'm glad you're with you.
All right, back to you guys.
would you, I smelled a little lack of sincerity there, kicking on our guy Beasley.
Steelers on top at halftime 2014. We'll take you to New York for the Nextel halftime report after this message and a word from your local CBS station.
CBS Thursday will keep you guessing. First,
this is your brain.
This is your.
Big game for both teams, Pittsburgh and Baltimore. Pittsburgh coach Bill Cowher caught up moments ago with our Beasley Reese on the sideline.
Bill, that was a great half of football for us, very entertaining. What did you tell the guys to get ready for the second half?
Well, I mean, we just got to go out and play. We got to stop Jamal Lewis in the running game, and we got to quit beating ourselves with penalties. That's the biggest thing that stopped us in the first half. But 30 minutes to go out there and play solid football, get a win, and we'll see what happens after that.
Thank you, coach.
Beasley, thank you. Tommy Maddox, 12 of 18, touchdown pass. not sacked, hit 8 different receivers. Pretty good first half.
And, you know, luckily for Bill Cowher, Baltimore kind of self-destructed at times on third down with the penalties, because Jamal Lewis has 71 yards rushing in the first half. Baltimore has to keep this up, stop making the mistakes, and like I said earlier in the game, they're not really impressed with Pittsburgh, and it really looks like they got to stop making the dumb mistakes, and they will make life pretty miserable for Tommy Maddox, Bill Cowher, and the Steelers.
And through 30 minutes of football, here are some of the numbers.
And the big thing, too, you're trailing 20-14, and you've got 2 turnovers. You really don't have to look too far but the nearest mirror to find out why you are where you are.
So Baltimore will kick off to begin the second half. And Matt Stover has it teed up as you take a look at Jamal Lewis, Hank Poteet, and Antoine Randall Allard back. And Antoine Randall up at about the 10-yard line for the Steelers. Running outside, and Stover, the kicker, brings him down. But he's into Baltimore territory at the 46 of 45-yard return.
Yeah, only a kicker is going to talk smack after a tackle where it happens 45 yards after the guy first touches the ball. Antoine Randall L does a nice job of returning this ball by himself. Because the wedge went forward to the middle of the field. The blocking was set up on the right side of the field. He saw something, went for it, and got a little smack for his trouble from Stover.
Sarah Lee in the backfield, 46-yard line, first and 10. The tight end, Tubman, is on the move. And Maddox right to work. Hines Ward, grabbed by McAllister. Brought down, gain of 4.
Be careful out of bounds like that by McAllister. You're going to get another flag.
To the 41-yard line. The numbers of our 2 quarterbacks. That Blake interception was in the end zone on a goal-to-go situation in the first half.
And the missing ingredient, 133 yards, 60 of which are to Todd Heap, but nothing since the first drive to the tight end, number 86.
Second down and 5 from the 41. Zeroway. All in the hole. Kimoyatu brings him down, close to a first down at about the 37-yard line.
Yeah, not having Jerome Bettis in the game, you notice this being a very different type of an offense, but I keep being reminded a little bit about the Oakland Raiders. You know, the Oakland Raiders give you Charlie Garner and Tyrone Wheatley, and they change things up between power and finesse and speed, and it's what Jerome Bettis will bring back to this team, will be the power factor when it comes time to come playoff time and gets into that ugly weather, foul conditions. That's custom made for the bus.
31 inside the 37. Zero away. And Quirk screws his way close to a first down and to get to about the 36. Looked like he was spinning on bodies that were beneath him, thus not being down.
That late effort with the ball, which we saw earlier, cost Jamal Lewis a fumble off Lee Flowers' knee that was recovered by Ricard for the touchdown. But so you see the blocking up front. Pretty nice blocking. Kelly Gregg inside holds his ground. Zeroway is trapped and stopped, but then stretches the ball out and almost loses it as he's stretching it out over the bodies in the pile.
I don't think he's got the first down.
First down's the 44. Ball to the about the 44 when he reaches the ball out.
Inside the 37, I think he's going to be shy by
not that much.
Yep. A little less than a yard. So for Bill Cowher, what do you do on fourth down?
I think if you're Bill Cowher in this situation with this offensive line, especially the interior 3, you can go for it here. You can blast this ball right up inside. You've got Maafala at fullback if you want a little oomph for your buck. You run right up inside this behind Fanica, Hardings, and Kendall Simmons, the rookie that's played so well at right guard, number 73. And don't forget the sneak, though. Tommy Maddox isn't much of a weapon sneaking.
Zero Lee in the backfield, 4th and 1. Kreider now positions himself back there with Zero Lee. Got to get inside the 36. Maddox for the first down, dropped by Plexico Burris at the 31. coverage by Baxter, and on downs, Pittsburgh gives it back to Baltimore.
And Plexico Burris was never really comfortable, was stumbling. Watch at the time of the break, right there. Stumble and turn, still not comfortable. I think that play call was very questionable to bad.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly Southwest Airlines for just $39 to $99 each way when you purchase by January 20th.
You are now free to move about the country.
Hey.
Hi.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Convertible. One good thing leads to another.
My name is David. I play offense. I play center.
I play guard.
I play defense. Vincent. And
sometimes I play tackle. Sometimes I play defense.
Cause I play right guard.
I play linebacker.
I play running back.
I play fullback.
I play right guard.
Tackle.
My name's Casey, and I play football.
They couldn't stand each other.
She's a pill.
Until they realized.
Hi.
They were perfect for each other. Tom Hanks, Meg Ryan, You've Got Mail. CBS Tonight at a special time.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
Pittsburgh could not convert on fourth and one and on downs. Baltimore gets it back, 37-yard line, first and 10. Lewis out of the backfield with a swing pass. Gildan's got him from behind, you think, because Mike Jones finishes him off and he picks up 18 yards on the game to the 45.
Let's go back down to that fourth play, Kevin, and take a look at something. Look at this soft spot right here. But keep something in mind. I said I didn't like the call, and I didn't like the call. But you could sneak it with Tommy Maddox if he doesn't have the bad ankle that he injured last Monday night. I think that went into the consideration when you come to call on the play and what you're going to ask for. But I still don't like the fact that you put all the pass possibilities into the pile on fourth and short.
First and 10, Baltimore at the Pittsburgh 45. Good block by Lewis. Picks up Joey Porter. Here goes play downfield and incomplete, looking for Todd Heap and a flag. Far side, 47-yard line.
Hey, they might be holding up front of the offensive line, but there's some serious holding going on in Todd Heap, too.
Holding. Number 31 offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Eight penalties on Baltimore today.
There's Todd Heap lined up at the tight end position right there. Watch him go down the field. There's a Lewis hold. Now watch, here's Jones. Little massage around the belly. Little hold on the jersey.
Chester Taylor is in first and 20. Back at the Baltimore 45. Taylor making a move. Gildan got him along with Kendrell Bell. Gain of a yard. Second down. Baltimore comes into today having lost two of their last three. Pittsburgh first place, obviously, winning the AFC North title. Second division title in as many years.
Hey, we really shouldn't be surprised. It's kind of a tight game here, only a six-point game with Baltimore involved. It seems like every Baltimore Raven game comes down to the last minute or so.
Taylor stays in, second down 20, blocked by John Ogden, time for Blake. And he's on the money. Pass caught, 40-yard line. grabbed by Travis Taylor, a 16-yard pickup. He's inside the Pittsburgh 40. They got to get to the 35 for a first down.
Well, you talk about part of the him being on the money, and one of the big decisions this offseason is going to be, what are you going to do with Jeff Blake if you're Baltimore? You know, he's made these passes. He doesn't have a contract. He'll be a free agent. Brian Billick easily says, hey, look, I didn't get enough of an evaluation on Chris Redman to say he's absolutely my guy. So that's a big question mark for them as to what they're going to do going into the 2003 season at quarterback.
Third and five, Taylor in the backfield from the Pittsburgh 40. And Blake to the side. He got the first down. It's Taylor on the fly. Eight-yard gain on third and five.
Hey, and if you're evaluating Jeff Blake for future consideration and what you're going to do, Kevin, I think one of the things that doesn't go into your consideration if you're Brian Billick is arm strength. And can he make all the throws? Because, folks, there isn't a throw in the game of football that number 11 can't make. And I don't think age is an issue either. He's been around the league for a while, but he's a real young veteran quarterback in his young 30s. He's got a good 4 or 5 years left in this league.
First and 10. Lewis back in, 32-yard line of Pittsburgh. The fake to Lewis, and time for Blake. Going deep down the side for Heath. Incomplete inside the five. It looked like Casey Hampton was held in the middle for Pittsburgh. Second down and 10.
Well, if it happened after the snap, it's probably a hold in the NFL. It's just a matter of when you're going to call it and who you're going to call it against. But look at that pass by Blake. I mean, that ball was about a foot too wide. But that was exactly in the general area where they wanted the ball, if there's such a thing as being exactly in the general area.
Those two catches were back early in the game on the opening drive of the game. Second down and 10. Pittsburgh 32 for Baltimore. Jamal Lewis breaks a tackle of Hampton. Grabbed by Bell and Flowers, then drilled. Gains about 7.5 on the play to the 25.
You know who loves that play more than anybody else for Baltimore? Without a doubt is Jeff Blake. You know, first and 10, it's incomplete. Second down, you give the ball to Jamal Lewis, and you say, look, if you're going to follow anybody, follow that guy right there, 75, Jonathan Ogden, and Mulatalo, number 64 at left guard. They open up a nice gaping hole in that defense, and Jamal Lewis gets 7.5 yards and puts his quarterback in a nice third and short situation.
Chester Taylor is in the backfield, third and 3, Baltimore at the Pittsburgh 25. Blake's second option, high and wide, uncatchable for Taylor. Picked up by Deshae Townsend on the far side.
Baltimore got away with one right there. Ethan Brooks, the right tackle, flinched before the snap, and it wasn't called.
So they're going to trot in Matt Stover. And it's fourth down, Randy, and about 3. Do you try for 3, as it looks like Baltimore is, or do you?
Not with Matt Stover. You know, I think Matt Stover is one of those kind of money in the bank kickers. I'm not cursing him right now, but this is a very, very accurate kicker who's got a strong leg.
43-yard try. And he drills it. So Baltimore creeps closer in an important game for both teams. 9:25 to play in the third quarter for Pittsburgh.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I've brought me some corn for poppin'. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow.
CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 37. Heineken, it's all about the beer. Heineken. And by Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
It was a Tahitian Christmas in Pittsburgh. That is a display in a small downtown here in Pittsburgh.
No in Tahiti?
After the field goal of 43 yards, the ensuing kickoff, 10-yard line, Antoine Randall getting a poteet block to the 40-yard line. And then tackled on the play by Alvin Porter, 30-yard return. Breathing space for Maddox and the Steelers, who lead it by three.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. What did we go wrong? Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. What did we go wrong? Hey there, Mr. Blue Sky, look around, see what you do. Everybody smiles at you.
Swan,
be a swan.
I don't think I'm swan material. Sorry, kind of new at this.
That's okay. It's good to try new things.
That's what I tell people about 10-10-220.
I use that. All my calls up to 20 minutes are 99 cents.
I haven't signed up for that.
You don't have to. Just dial 10-10-220, then 1, and the number.
That's easy.
It sure is. I knew you could do it. Help, I think I'm stuck.
Dial 10-10-220.
Access NFL.com now and America Online. Get live game day coverage and real-time stats at AOL keyword NFL.com.
A wild shootout. Cody Pickett, the Pac-10's leading passer, drives Washington against the dangerous firepower of Purdue. The Wells Fargo Sun Bowl, Tuesday on CBS.
Tommy Maddox has thrown a touchdown pass today. Amos Erloy with a one-yard touchdown run, couple field goals. That's our story. 2017 Pittsburgh. And after the Baltimore field goal and kickoff, here's the first down handoff to Amos Erloy. Blocking by Hines Ward. Boy, she's a terrific blocker as a wide receiver. A first down run of 12 yards to the Baltimore 48-yard line. Well, Randy Cross and all of our viewers, who do you think deserves to be the NFL Coach of the Year? Cast your vote at NFL.com.
Of those five? I think it's easy. I'd go Andy Reid. Of course, I'd also have...
I think I'm Fisher. I think
you're going with Fisher? He's done a nice job. But I think Andy Reid and Mike Sherman in Green Bay have dealt with their adversity the best.
Well put. 48-yard line. Fake the Sherman. Here they come. Streaming in on him. And that is Bernardo Harris, an ex-Green Bay Packer, in a sack. The first one today by the Baltimore Ravens. The first time the Maddox has felt any kind of pressure on him that deep in the pocket all afternoon.
Hey, if you're Bill Cowher right now, I think you might want to send a little message to your football team in the way of a wake-up call, because after a great return by Randall L., you don't want to squander this kind of field position. And giving up a sack like that to Bernardo Harris, that was a nice defensive call by the Ravens.
Second and 18 for Matuma'afala in the backfield with Kreider. Blocked by Gandy, and outside they go to Kreider. And intercepted on the deflection by James Trapp. On the ricochet, he gets it. The first Pittsburgh turnover. And Baltimore will get it at the 47-yard line of the Steelers.
Well, Kevin, wake-up calls come in many forms. Sometimes they're verbal. Sometimes they're physical. And other times it is a form of momentum. Ball popped in the air. Trapp stays with it. Momentum to the Ravens. Wake up.
He's sponsored by Hewlett-Packard, HP Digital Imaging. When it's this easy, why not? And by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Gorgeous Heinz Field here.
Yeah, that earlier shot of the helmets sitting on top of those little poles. Those are helmet heaters.
Are they?
Yeah.
I like that.
That's in case you want to be a hothead.
47-yard line after the hole. Ethan Brooks just jumped a little quickly there. This is a Baltimore possession after the James Trapp interception.
Ball start. 77 offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Premature football.
Trapp. Raff had his third interception right there, the ex-Raider, and that is the 24th as a team for Baltimore, a new franchise record that is the number one interception mark in the AFC currently.
And you remember back to the last time these two teams played, his stepping on Plexico Burris' face started a little tussle that got Burris thrown out of the game.
You called it first and 15 with the penalty. Blake winding up and looking for Heath, who is cracked but holds on somehow, some way. Brent Alexander nails him, 21-yard gain, and the first catch since the first series for Heap, and it's a first down to the 31.
You saw this out of Shockey yesterday. Yeah, you saw a catch and a hit from the anti-Shockey. Todd Heap, they do a lot of things similar between the whistles.
Yes.
They play good, hard football. Everything after the whistles and in the huddle and everything, there's nothing similar between these two good, good young tight ends.
Heap, the number two tight end NFL receiver. With that catch right there, first and 10, 31-yard line. Blake winding up, going for Heap in the end zone, and caught! Allah, Jeremy Shockey, a flag has been thrown. A 31-yard touchdown as it stands right now. It is a touchdown. It's against the Pittsburgh Steelers. You speak of Jeremy Shockey, that's exactly what he did yesterday in Giant Stadium.
But you know what? He didn't get up immediately and yap in the guy's face.
All right. Number 20 defense. Penalty decline. Play results in a touchdown.
How about that? Baltimore is on top for the first time today.
We talked about Ed. We talked to Ed Reed and to McAllister. They said, he lines up on you. What are you thinking? They said, I'm thinking jump ball. And this is Dwayne Washington, the veteran corner. He knew it was a jump ball, and he lost by a lot.
And the extra point by Stover, a 31-yard touchdown reception by Todd Heap. He is Pro Bowl bound in his second year out of Arizona State. A spectacular grab, and the Baltimore Ravens on top by four.
What's brown to me? One word.
Todd Heap's doing a little dental check on the sideline after that hit he took before the touchdown. Gargling. Yeah, they're all there.
Stover's kickoff. Hank Poteet takes it out to the 31. That's a career day right there, 116 yards. That is the mark.
You know, kind of like Marvin Harrison, who you saw on the pregame show, the nice piece about him. Todd Heap's another one of those players where the loudest thing about him are his actions. Not necessarily his words, but on the field, he's a screamer by the way he plays.
You see zero in back of Maddox, 2 minutes on the move. 32, first and 10. Carter the lead block. Marvell Smith with the block and cutting the other way. Zero away. Baxter had him. Reed couldn't bring him down. Finally, it's Mitchell. About the 39. It's a gain of 8, and he ran about 18. Well, Baltimore is still alive in the playoff race. They lead right now, so a win today would at least propel them into a different level. But they need losses by Patriots. The Jets play later on against Green Bay and right on down the line. Patriots are losing, as you can see right there, 21-10 to Miami.
And in interest of the Steeler fans, talking about that week off, look at Tennessee and Houston at 6-0. And that's a lucky David Carr pass away from being a deficit.
Second down two for Matamala Fala in the backfield from the 40. There's a block, and Maddox has time to the side for Burks. In front of Baxter, and a first down to the Baltimore 42 and a gain of 18.
And we kept mentioning Todd Heap when Baltimore had the ball, saying, where is he? He is the key player. Well, Plexico Burris for the Pittsburgh Steelers, since Tommy Maddox has been the quarterback, is the key player in this offense. It's hard to say with a lot of teams that everything spins off a wide receiver. It's usually a running back or a quarterback. This offense spins off of Plexico now. When he's successful and he's got it going on, this offense is moving.
42-yard line for Matamala Fala in the backfield. And Maddox on first and 10. Moves up, hit, brought down. Kiboyatu comes in and makes the grab. It is the second sack today by the Baltimore defense.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. When we talked to him Friday, Tommy Maddox had that stim machine with him. and he showed his ankle. I said, the stim machine's obviously, you know, with a quarterback this time of the year, you're never really sure, quite sure what it is for. He kind of pulled his leg, pant leg up and showed me his ankle. And that ankle is purple and swollen. It looked about twice the size of the other ankle. I mean, it's amazing this guy is able to play at all and move around in the pocket.
44-yard line, second down and 12. Zeroway in the backfield. Here comes Mitchell. And Zeroway's got Fanick out in front. Blocked by Tooman, and Reed brings him down. And about the 34. Gain of 10. Zeroway was nothing but window dressing, kind of luring in Mitchell from the side.
You know, when you're talking about a screen, the key to the screens is the center, the guard, and the tackle. The tackle's going to bring his player up, then go for a cut. The guard comes out, the center comes out, the back delays, and then the linemen head downfield and get blocks. Nice block by Tooman, blocked by Hardings, and then it's just up to the back to find the soft spot.
Fuala Tamalafala is in. Third, long two, inside the 35. And Fu gets the call. Trader with the block, sealed it off. That's a first down run. You got a lot of beef back there. Dan Kreider and Chris Fuamatsuma-Afala, 8-yard gain. And Kreider nicely steered everybody inside.
You saw Anthony Mitchell there, the safety at the end of that play. With Maafala coming at him, he was looking for the nearest shin. You're not going to go for a thigh. That's going to hurt you, or a knee. He was going for Maafala's shins, trying to knock some weight out from underneath him and hoping he gets help.
It's like a chicken dinner.
A shin? Look how big a shin is on a chicken.
From the 26, Maafala again. Hartwell wraps him up, brings him down after a gain of about 3, down to the 23.
That might be the new diet. Chicken shin diet.
You know how many chicken wings?
You know how many chicken shins you could eat and still stay skinny?
It's like eating crawfish or something.
Question is that protein or carbo?
All with protein.
Nice answer right here for Pittsburgh in this offense. You know, Fuamatsuma-Afala has been a nice add in this offense coming back from the injuries. This is a great answer to Baltimore's drive.
Zeroway is in, seventh play of the drive, second down and 7. The fake to Zeroway. Fanick's buying time, looking to the end zone for Burst. Intercepted by Mitchell.
Oh, stay in there.
And he's going to bring it out. And find some running room and give some better position. As opposed to the touchback and staying in, Marvell Smith brings him down. A 30-yard return, and Mitchell gets his third interception of the year.
And Marvell Smith's a little slow getting off the ground. He was a little dinged up earlier in that drive. But, you know, when it's not quite right for you, it's just not quite right. And it's hard to get it turned around in the other direction. And Pittsburgh, for all the positives, have come up with these mistakes. That's a nice athletic play by Mitchell making that catch. It's interesting he brought it back, and it's to his credit, he did a heck of a nice job bringing it back. But being able to corral this thing, this is kind of disproves the old, if you could catch, you'd be a wide receiver for the defensive backs. Because all three of those were good catches.
And if that's Cornell Brown they're looking at right there, got poked in the eye. If you're wondering, he did intercept it kind of on the goal line, but he fell in the end zone, so he would have been given a touchback had he decided just to leave it in the end zone. There you see Anthony Mitchell. Maddox throws the pick. Maddox has thrown 2 interceptions today. Trapp got it on a ricochet, and then Mitchell right there. I think we had a late hit.
There's Hines Ward right there on the ground. In the vernacular of the officials, giving Brown the business in the face, gouging him, looked like in the eyes. That's a little above and beyond the call of action.
And finally, from the 29, first and 10, Jamal Lewis, grabbed by Joey Porter after a gain of a yard, second down and 9. The league will definitely look at that.
Porter and Schmidt.
There is some bad feelings between these teams. If you go back to week 8 of the season, the last time these two teams met in Baltimore, tempers flared as Plexico Burress and James Trapp were both ejected in the second quarter for fighting, and fines were levied by the NFL.
And Burress, what, middle of the second quarter, had 5 catches for 55 yards and 2 touchdowns at that point. Totally changed the game plan. of the Pittsburgh Steelers offense when Burris went out of that game.
This looks like Benny Anderson, who is down. It is. They're starting right guard, a former player in the XFL, a two-year starter. And down right now.
For an offensive lineman, it's not usually the problems you see, it's the ones you don't see. When you're an offensive lineman like 66 right here, Benny Anderson, watch him pull and watch what happens. It's usually either from the side or from the backside. Because you can see Casey Hampton, you're blocking on him, that's fine. But what you don't see is your own guy, Ethan Brooks, and Smith, Aaron Smith, 91, fall on the back of your legs.
So they will bring in a new lineman once they cart Anderson off.
I would think it would have to be Casey Rabach. At least he's the guy with the most experience as the backups.
He has already started
Baltimore
a couple games at left guard and at center this season. And it is Casey Rabach out of Wisconsin. That's a good point. A lot of guys getting a lot of experience on this young Ravens team.
Well, that's something Brian Billick says he knows he's going to have starting next year. A lot of people say, well, gee, I've got to play somebody. I'm not sure what they are. He'll have backups next year that'll be second and third year players that'll have starts in the NFL in the teens and 20s because of the experience and the playing time they've had to get this year.
Second down and 9 at the 30. Maddox was just picked off. That leads to this Baltimore possession. Blake fires it, caught by Taylor, 38-yard line, close to a first down. Tackled by linebacker Mike Jones, taking the place of the injured James Ferrier.
Hey, you want to tell me that crowds can't smell sort of team attitudes? You mentioned there's some bad blood between these teams and sort of the gouging in the eyes by Hines Ward. And some of the other plays and some of the other actions in this game have got this crowd really into the action right now.
That's a WWF move, isn't it? Gouging, the so-called hidden object?
Yeah, giving them the business. Ben Dreyf.
That's right.
Philadelphia, San Francisco back in the early 80s.
Yeah.
I was standing there looking at the guy when he called it.
Now, when you interview Hines Ward, he's got a perpetual smile on his face. He does not. He's got this wide receiver position, but this linebacker mentality and linebacker body.
Well, you learned a long time ago on the schoolyard and in the playgrounds, you always looked out for the quiet ones that were smiling.
Right.
It wasn't the loud ones that were talking bad. It was the ones that were quiet that would get you.
Third down and inches for the Baltimore Ravens at their 39. Lewis in the backfield. Blake tries to take it himself and nudges with the line toward the 40. John Ogden, and they give him a first down. John Ogden at the bottom of that pile.
I tell you, they went to the toughest part of the defense.
Well, they did.
They went right at Casey Hampton and Kendrell Bell that were right there over Mike Flynn, the center's head.
Pittsburgh player is down. It's hard to Kendrell Bell, who, by the way, missed some time earlier this season with a
high ankle sprain.
High ankle sprain.
He's limping, and it was the left ankle.
That is not a good sign.
Oh, no.
The playoffs approaching. He's made a difference the last month with this defense.
See, there's Kendrell Bell right there, right in the middle, right over Flynn. He gets caught up in that pile, and Muatalo and two or three other players fall right on top of the back and the legs of Kendrell Bell.
Larry Foote will take his place, number 50. It's first down and 10 after the quarterback keeper by Blake, shy of the 40-yard line. Lewis tries to squirt free. Grabbed by Mike Jones, picks up 5 on the play up to the 44.
Now, if it was a 5-yard run, would it be a slither? But if it's a short run, it's a squirt?
Well, if he's hit, it doesn't have any fluidity to the move.
Fluidity?
Yeah.
If you're fluid, it's a slither.
Yeah, you slither.
You slither fluidly.
Just like that.
Well,
hey, it's taken 17 games for you to figure this out.
Well, you know, whether he's slithering or being fluid or what, this is what Baltimore wants. They want to drive to get either points or pin Pittsburgh's offense back.
Second down, long 4. Lewis That bangs his way right into that line. Again, Mike Jones is right there. Mike Jones, you might recall, was the guy that made the Super Bowl saving tackle for the St. Louis Rams against Tennessee a couple years ago.
And he's in the middle of the Pittsburgh defense, which really is going to be tested the most, Kevin, with this attitude of Brian Billick. Remember, they're bad, not bad, but they're basically hurt at wide receivers. They've been in two tight end a lot with the fullback Ricard. So they pretty much come out and said, we're going to smash this at you.
Third down and four from the 45. Taylor's in the backfield. And Blake winds and throws, and he's got Travis Taylor for a first down at the Pittsburgh 36. A gain of 19 on third down and four.
Yeah, this is set up by Todd Heap, the tight end. Todd Heap is going to line up a tight end and stretch it this way and set things up in front of Travis Taylor. See the hole in front of Travis Taylor in the defense? That's because Todd Heap was out towards the sideline.
The Baltimore Ravens scored 10 unanswered third quarter points, and they lead as we go to the fourth, 24-20. We're back to Pittsburgh after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL.
The evidence is clear. Missing the People's Choice nominee for favorite new drama would be a crime.
The CSI Miami. It's all here. CBS Monday.
The search is on. Don't miss the Star Search premiere. CBS Wednesday, January 8th.
Introducing all new America Online 8.0. We listen to you and designed AOL 8.0 with hundreds of exciting new features.
Welcome.
New AOL email sort gets you to important mail faster. New AOL Call Alert lets you be online and never miss important phone calls. Choose a welcome screen tailored to your interests. There are hundreds of new features to easily connect you to the people and things you care about most. New America Online 8.0. Call 1-800-4-ONLINE or get a free startup disk at these locations.
How long have you been waiting?
You live for technology. Love your handheld and digital camera. Why not choose a tire that's as technologically advanced? Bridgestone. Created with a vision, tested with a vengeance. By a brand that's been passionate about quality tires for over 70 years. Bridgestone. Welcome to the future.
So how's it coming?
Good. This one looks pretty exotic.
Cool.
Mosquito nets. What's that? Maybe not that exotic.
Great.
Everything you need to choose the hotel that's right for you.
Expedia.com.
NFL Sunday Ticket is brought to you in part by Expedia.com.
That is not a good picture if you're a Steelers fan.
The Steeler defense is, as Bill Cowher has been saying, taking advantage of backup quarterbacks and stuffing people on the run, and that's been the key, has been Kendrell Bell.
First play, fourth quarter, from the 35, first and 10. Blake, great time. Fires a pass to the side, which is hauled in by Heath. And he was grabbed on the side by Deshae Townsend. It's a gain of 12. It's another first down to the Pittsburgh 23. To the sideline and Beasley Reese.
All right, guys, injuries on both sides. First, you're talking about Kendrell Bell. He's gone in with the left ankle injury. They're going to do some x-rays. And Benny Anderson, the guard for the Ravens, was taken in by Carr for the same reason. His is a right ankle. Back to you.
So Casey Robach, thank you, Beasley, is in at that right guard position. First and 10. And Ricard, who has two touchdowns today, brought down by Foot and by Gilden. Foot is taking the place of the just injured Kendrell Bell. Gain of three.
Okay, so far, the Pittsburgh defense in the last couple drives hasn't showed me much that would dissuade me if I'm Matt Cavanaugh, the offensive coordinator, and Brian Billick on the Baltimore side of saying I can't keep trying to feed the ball to 86 Todd Heap.
Second down, seven. Lewis the back. Sam Gash in for the first time. He'll be the lead blocker for Lewis, but not much there. Wrapped up and brought down by Rodney Bailey, who already has a sack today. No gain on the play. This Bailey, another one of these great Pittsburgh defenders, Kind of coming out of no place, five sacks this season.
Well, you know, they don't come out of what you would say no place, Kevin. I think this is one of the strongest organizations in the NFL. Maybe the best organization in the NFL in identifying what is their kind of player. And Bill Cowher and the entire front office stock this team full of players that may not play for everybody, but when they get here, they're definitely Pittsburgh Steeler type of players.
Third down, seven. Gash in the backfield with Taylor on the Pittsburgh 20. Blake across the middle, Taylor, and chased by the Steelers into the end zone. No yellow on the field. A Baltimore touchdown. And Chester Taylor with his second receiving touchdown on third and seven. He is in, and Baltimore extends their lead.
What an excellent call by Matt Kavanaugh, the offensive coaches. There's Chester Taylor lining up in the backfield. Everybody's worrying about the passes outside. Look what that does in the middle of the field. Safeties are thinking help to the outside for the receivers, Taylor and Todd Heap. It leaves the entire middle open for Taylor, the running back.
Stover's extra point is in. Maddox getting intercepted, and Baltimore and Brian Billick cash in. 17 unanswered points by the Baltimore Ravens.
What is it?
It's a UBA.
The UBA?
Universal Business Adapter.
What's it do?
It connects anything to everything.
What's this for?
Your laptop, your mainframe, call center, Unix servers, Linux servers, internet, supply chain, payroll system, HR, email.
Slick.
Is it affordable?
Fast.
Easy?
Very.
Does it work in Europe?
You need an adapter.
Just because a toothbrush is electric doesn't mean it works like a Sonicare. It has patented Sonic technology. Whiter, healthier teeth in 28 days, guaranteed. Ask your dental professional about Sonicare.
Chicago Bear Brian Urlacher and his mom brought Miss Patel new Campbell's Chunky Herb Roasted Chicken with potatoes and garlic, with big chunks of savory chicken. Filled up right at lunchtime, Miss Patel bravely ended nap time.
The phrase average Joe was coined for a reason. Joe's the guy who wears a shirt that says Joe on it. Joe doesn't steal the girl, he's the guy you pal around with, but not since the playoffs. Now Joe's a bachelor from Alabama who changes everything. Joe's a guy who carries New York City on two bad knees and guarantees victory. Joe's not just a name, it's an idea. Fathers expect more from a kid named Joe. That's how big the playoffs are. They took the name Joe and made it Joe.
Monday for comedy that's easy to get into.
Zip me, please.
Not a problem.
Keep it with the King.
Zip me, please.
On the King of Queens. Then, Guestier presents Great Moments in Family Vacations.
So that's what stunk up the car. I thought it was you.
Have fun.
Someone even left a coonskin cap in here.
Guestier after the King of Queens, CBS Monday.
20-yard touchdown reception moments ago by running back rookie Chester Taylor. And Stover's kickoff. Poteet from the 15-yard line. And grabbed and brought down by Anthony Mitchell at the 32.
Hey, you know, Kevin, they've had good field position. Last two possessions, though, lost on downs and an interception. Maddox and this offense have to finish off a drive.
Well, Miami is on top of New England. Tennessee is leading Houston. Look at Atlanta on top of Cleveland, and Carolina and lead on top of New Orleans.
And if you're a Baltimore fan, that Cleveland trailing and New England trailing fit into your formula.
Maddox threw an interception last time out there. First and 10 here in the CLA. Sides by a couple. But ball's down. Peter Bulwer knocked him. Gain of two, and they're booing here in Pittsburgh. They want more fireworks on offense. The team's down by 11. 17 unanswered points.
And the first words that kind of leap to your mind while looking at the scoreboard in this situation in Pittsburgh, you got to be kidding me. You know, but this is the kind of team Baltimore has been. They will stand in there toe-to-toe with them.
Second down and eight from the 35. Pocket crumbles. Maddox is down and inhaled on the play by Riddick Parker, his first sack of the season. the ex-New England Patriot and Seattle Seahawk.
And really a delayed rush from Parker, who was at the top of the screen, lined up against the left tackle, Gandy. And like I made the comment earlier in the third quarter, Pittsburgh didn't get the memo. They didn't know that they had the team that they had in Baltimore.
All three of those sacks, by the way, by Baltimore in the second half. Third and 13 from the 30. Maddox, pocket crumbles again. Now he's on the run, has to get to the 43 and throws outside for Antoine Randall, who lunges ahead. He'll be close to a first down at the 43, pick up about 12.
Ball's going to be spotted right at the 43, Kevin, right in the middle of the line.
Third and 13, you're right, Randy. Very tight, very close. If they are short and it is fourth and inches, what do you do? There's a lot of time left, 11:28.
Right, Tommy Maddox made that play. That's not the kind of play he's supposed to make with a bad ankle. He's going to come up just short.
They're going to go for it.
They got to go for it.
You like the call?
I like going for it, heck yeah. You got to give your team a spark. You got to tell that offensive line that's supposedly so good that you think they're that good. I think what you don't do is you don't throw the ball here. I think what you do is you run the ball. You do what you should have done that last fourth down. You pound it inside, and Mike Mularkey right there, the offensive coordinator, has got to make a point inside of just saying, hey, look, if we take this ball over, if we take control of this game again, it's going to start with my offensive line up front.
Fuamatu Maafala and Kreider in the backfield, fourth and inches.
First, bottom of the screen, Kevin. That's where he threw it last time.
43-yard line. Fuamatu Maafala has the first down. Hines Ward with the block. Out of bounds at the 41. That only gets him a first down. He gets a pretty good position in Baltimore territory. That's a season-long 17-yard run by Chris Fuamatu Maafala.
And much like Darryl Johnston of the Cowboys, Deuce Staley was in the studio with the Philadelphia Eagles. Fu is greeted by what sounds like booze when he makes their kind of plays. That was nice call by Mike Mularkey upstairs. Misdirection. Took a long time to happen. It was a dangerous call, but it worked perfectly.
Saraway back in, first and 10, Baltimore 41. Maddox going deep, looking for Hines Ward. And jousting all the way with McAllister. And incomplete with no yellow on the field. Second down.
Now you use the word jousting. Perfect description. They're jousting with their elbows. They're jousting with their arms. They're jousting with their hips and legs and feet. And a lot of contact. Good concentration on the offensive side and very nice defensive execution and technique by Chris McAllister.
By the way, Plexico Burris only one catch in the second half. Second and 10 for the 41. Saraway. Nice play by Dallas Thomas. Gets away from Craig and then smothered by Bernardo Harris for no gain on the play. So now it is third down and 10 from the 41.
And you're getting close to the time of the fourth quarter where you start saying there's a time issue. You mentioned earlier, gee, there's lots of time. Would you have to go for it? But once you get inside of 10 minutes, you start moving down anywhere in the 8 to 7 minute standpoint. When you're down by 11 points, you're looking at a time issue when you need two touchdowns to go ahead.
Maddox today, 16 of 26, a touchdown and two interceptions. From the 41, third and 10. Moving up in the pocket, he's got to get to the 31, has the first down, and zigzags his way to the 21. A play like that can resuscitate an offense. A career-long 21-yard scramble.
He scrambled up to get up the big play and the big completion earlier in the drive. And here you've got a quarterback who's a pocket passer and basically has hamburger for a left ankle. Saying the heck with the injury, the heck with the ankle, I got to make something happen.
That may be the spark the Steelers need. 21-yard line. Make it the 20. And it's first and 10 with Saraway in the backfield. A Kreider block. And Saraway chiseling his way for 5 to the 15-yard line.
Chisholm. Let's
write it down. And some of the numbers for some of our leaders today.
Tommy Maddox trying to overcome one of the very poor numbers for him. Amos Zaraway and Fuamatu Maafala key the running game. And Hines Ward and Plexico Burris, who we had not seen. You mentioned it. More Burris means more points.
15-yard line, second down, 5. Here comes Zaraway, cutting out a dime. And then Kelly Gregg wrestles him down from behind after a gain of 9 to the 5. It is a first down. It's first and goal, Pittsburgh, with about 8.5 in the clock running here in the fourth quarter.
Well, you know, there's a lot of running backs in this league that can cut on a dime on this kind of surface. But the difference between Amos Zaraway and that kind of a run is Zaraway leaves a little change on the ground after he makes that cut. Because this is not a very nice football field to run on. Not a good field to be cutting on. And it's harder for the defense to cut than it is for the runner.
It is. Reese shot it. First and goal at the 5. Zaraway in the backfield. Zaraway the call. Runs into his blocker Simmons and still bounces in for a touchdown. He was like a pinball and found it. And Pittsburgh is back in business.
Pittsburgh looked sluggish before this drive, but Tommy Maddox, Fuamatu Maafala, the offensive line, and especially Amos Zaraway decided that sluggish wasn't going to work. And Pittsburgh is going to go for 2. I like this decision.
10 plays, 67-yard drive. Now going for 2. Zaraway remains in the game. Hand off, Antoine Randall out with the pitch out to Zaraway. Does not get in. A clever play. And Baltimore didn't bite.
That's a play that works very well against somebody that hasn't seen you, that doesn't know your trick tendencies. But Baltimore and Brian Billick know this defense, know this offense very well. They were ready. Excellent execution by Hartwell in the defense.
Never pay interest. Plus, no payments until 2004. Will anyone else ever offer a deal better than this? Never pay interest when you buy a new Mitsubishi. Plus, make no payments until 2004. The fastest growing Japanese car company in America wants to grow faster than ever. It's the Mitsubishi year-end sales event. But hurry, this deal ends January 2nd.
I am a soldier. An army of one. Even though I am part of the strongest army in the world, I am my own force. With the latest technology, training, and support, who I am has become better than who I was. And I'll be the first to tell you, the might of the U.S. Army doesn't lie in numbers. It lies in soldiers like me, Specialist Mark DeCarli. I am an army of one, and you can see my strength.
For over 8 years, DirecTV has brought America the best in television entertainment, and our customers have shown their appreciation in many unique ways. We simply figured it was an emotion they couldn't put into words. Until now. DirecTV, ranked number 1 in customer satisfaction among satellite and cable subscribers by J.D. Power and Associates. Get a 2-room DirecTV system with installation for under $50.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Michelob Ultra. Lose the carbs, not the taste. Mitsubishi Motors. Standard is not an option. Are you in? And by DirecTV. Movies, music, and exclusive sports from the leader in digital satellite entertainment.
After that nice run of 5 yards by Zaraway, the touchdown by Baltimore, the short kickoff. Chester Taylor fumbles the ball at the 30-yard line. It's a little scramble, and Pittsburgh says they've got it.
Of course they did.
This is a huge recovery by either team here.
I think they do have it.
How'd you like it? Who's it? What are you saying?
I think Pittsburgh does have it.
Look at them digging the bodies up.
Well, down to the back end of the dog pile was nothing but black jerseys. And that's where the ball was.
They've got Larry Foote down there, and it is Pittsburgh's ball. That is the third turnover today by Baltimore. Pittsburgh's got two.
And the best news for the Pittsburgh defense is Baltimore's offense doesn't have to take the field because of that fumble, because they've scored all three times in this half. They've had the ball. Now all the pressure goes back on the Baltimore defense. It just left the field.
Larry Foote fell on the ball. Larry Foote is the guy who's taking the place of the injured Kendrell Bell. And that's the turnover story for the Steelers today. 0-8, two touchdown runs. Tommy Maddox, a touchdown pass. He has been intercepted twice. But here is a huge turnover at the Baltimore 31, 0-8 in the backfield. Pittsburgh first and 10. Zeroway. They clog the middle with Reed and Mulware. Gain of one. Second down, nine. Mark him at the 30. 106 yards on the ground for Zeroway. Two touchdowns taking the place of the injured and inactive Jerome Bettis.
And to use an old term used on another team, nice thunder and lightning kind of combination between Zeroway and Fuamatu Maafala. But I will also say again, Plexico Burris and the matchup at the bottom of the screen.
Second down, nine from the 30. And Maddox going outside. He's got the fullback Kreider chased by Bowler. Brought down and close to a first down at the 22. Gains 8 yards on the play. Playoff implications for both teams today. If Pittsburgh wins and Tennessee loses, they get a first-round bye. Huge for any coach, including Bill Kelly. If Baltimore wins, they remain alive. But a lot of things have got to happen. Cleveland is losing. New England is losing. Denver and San Diego play other teams. Later today, the Jets will host Green Bay. Tennessee right now in a close game with Houston. Third and one. For Hunter Malafana. A block by Kreider that gets through his first down. Kreider delivered a crushing block. Gain of eight. Mark him at the 13.
Go back to that fourth and short. Going for it on fourth down. That told your line you believed in him. That told your running backs we're going to give you the chance. Zeroway carried the majority of the load on that last drive. Maafala made the play on that big fourth down. And Mike Mularka, the offensive coordinator, has got the right rhythm right working right now with his play call.
Zeroway back in, first and 10, 13-yard line for the Steelers. Zeroway sets a couple tackles, then is brought down. Again, Cornell Brown and Peter Bulwer, gain of one. And they'll mark him at about the 12-yard line. Zeroway, by the way, his third 100-yard rushing game.
Hey, you know, Ed Reed, the rookie safety, number 20, could have had Zeroway in the backfield, Kevin. You kind of remind you of that conversation from yesterday, didn't it?
Yes.
You know, the quick fill, the enthusiasm. He goes, and Ray Lewis keeps telling me, you've got to learn to break down.
Slow down, just a minute.
Slow down and be able to make the tackle, because that could have been a 3 or 4 yard loss.
Good time to bring that up. Second down and nine for the trap. Max. That's Hines Ward. And about the seven, a gain of five, and short of a first down by three. Word out of Houston, Tennessee has just scored a touchdown. 5 minutes left right there. 12-3 Titans. It's third down and four. Fuamata Maafala is back in. Maddox's platoon, four receivers. At the Baltimore 7.
Perfect time for a jump ball in the end zone.
Maddox. And going short. Has got the first down. Hines Ward. The Pro Bowler. And record-setting wide receiver for the Steelers has it at the 2. First and goal for Pittsburgh.
And it was a nice formation. Good play calling. Talking about Mike Mularka and the job he's doing. You've got Hines Ward and Plexico Burris on the same side of the field. You bring Plexico Burris up into the end zone. See, Burris goes here into the end zone. Hines Ward comes underneath him right there. That's just a perfect play by the Pittsburgh Steelers.
First and goal at the two. Zeroway gets the handoff. Tripped up nicely by Ed Reed. That's some of the speed you're talking about, right?
Not much of a breakdown, right? That was the pure enthusiasm and speed. That's when you don't have to break down. You get there so fast, the other guys aren't even ready for you. There's Ed Reed coming off the corner, number 20. You know, he did this down in Miami when they played Ricky Williams and the Miami Dolphins. Ricky Williams bounced off and spun into the end zone for a touchdown. He just got there that half a step faster. Zeroy wasn't as ready for him as Williams had been about 2 months ago.
Second down, goal at the five. Red zone offense today at Pittsburgh. Ward is in motion. Zeroy in the backfield. Manning slips. Hit and brought down by Ed Hartwell back at the eight. The fourth Baltimore sack today. And Hartwell nails his third of the year. Just when you think Baltimore is going to lie and die, they come back with a wonderful defensive play like that.
It was Ed Hartwell right there, coming in the defense in motion. That was good timing. The offensive line, he melded right into the sort of the mush, and they weren't able to spot him. But Ed Hartwell, 13 tackles in a sack. You call that filling in? He played well with Ray Lewis. Might be playing better without him.
Fuamatama'a foul in the backfield. Third and goal at the eight. Mannix held. Slips away. Being chased to the end zone. Touchdown! Antoine Randall!
This is Tommy Maddox buying time, and the reason he can buy time, his offensive line does a job the Oakland Raiders offensive line to be jealous of. Buy him extra time. How many times did you see Rich Gannon do that yesterday? Because that offensive line gave him the time. The Pittsburgh line gave him 5 seconds to throw that pass.
So now they're going to try for two. The Steelers this year on two-point conversions are 4-5. They missed moments ago. It's Fuamatama'a Fala in motion. The fake to him. To the end zone for two, and they got it. Plexico Burris. That puts Pittsburgh up by three.
They gave him the window dressing. They gave him the motion. And they drug the big guy along the backside.
Feeding on those high interest rates.
I just switched our balance over to a Capital One no hassle card. You're gonna save $500 a year.
$500?
Switch your high interest balance to the Capital One no hassle card for the nation's lowest long-term fixed rates. You could save up to $500 a year.
What's in your wallet?
You know what impossible means? Don't even try it. Impossible can't happen. Impossible says, what are you crazy? That's impossible. But not anymore. Not since the playoffs. Now impossible is just a starting point. Impossible is a negotiation. Impossible means Tom Brady, a second-string quarterback drafted in the sixth round, can catapult millions into euphoria. That's the magnitude of the playoffs. They've changed the English language. They've made impossible possible.
CBS Thursday.
This is your brain.
This is your brain on CSI.
Very nice.
Don't miss 2 hours of TV's most addictive show. Then it's the first without a trace of 2003.
We don't know what she looks like, and we don't know when she disappeared.
This ought to be easy.
Get into the mystery without a trace after 2 hours of CSI. Thursday.
Antoine Randall just caught his second career touchdown reception. Pittsburgh cashes in on the fumbled kickoff return of Chester Taylor of Baltimore. Maddox has thrown two touchdowns today. And that sails over Lamont Brightfield's head and trickles out of the end zone.
But it's important to remember about Baltimore, Kevin. Brian Baylor's got a whole team full of Alfred E. Newman. You know, wouldn't they worry?
If you think all batteries are the same, consider this. When monitoring a patient after open heart surgery, the brand of battery hospitals trust most is Duracell. Duracell, trusted everywhere. Still think all batteries are the same? Consider this. When IMAX needed power for their camera, they trusted Duracell. Up there or down here on Earth. Duracell, trusted everywhere.
Kumquats. I love kumquats.
I don't know what kumquats look like, but I got some great looking tomatoes. Do we need tomatoes?
No, I just got tomatoes.
They got kiwis, they got some red things here.
Hey, aren't you that guy?
No, sorry, I'm not him. What about bananas?
Come on, I know
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I get that all
you.
The time. I'm sorry.
You're on television.
Well.
In commercials.
Hey, pal, I don't do commercials.
I'm sorry.
That's what you say, hon. There's five bananas too many to get brown, you know.
With its new available Power Stroke diesel and five-speed automatic torque shift transmission that generates 560 pound-feet of torque and 325 horsepower, the Ford F-Series Super Duty pulls faster and easier than any other diesel pickup. Ford F-Series, the best-selling truck on the planet.
Well, guess that settles that.
Yep.
It's built Ford tough.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Nextel. Nextel, how business gets done. And by Duracell, trusted everywhere.
Sold out crowd, Heinz Field with Randy Cross, Beasley Reese, Kevin Harlan. Playoff implications here. Baltimore blew a fourth quarter lead last week. And hurt themselves trying to stay alive in the playoffs. They're on a respirator right now. They're down by three. First and 10 at the 20. Lewis in the backfield. And Lewis dances and then is brought down nicely by defensive lineman Aaron Smith. A loss of a yard. Second down and 11. Three timeouts for each team remaining.
And considering they have those timeouts, I'm kind of surprised there's a lack of real urgency by the Baltimore Ravens. They're just going to let this thing go down to the two-minute warning. Brian Billick doesn't quite agree with his quarterback's philosophy here.
Why not take a timeout?
The blue one there.
You've waited all year for this moment. Triple X. Buy it on special edition DVD December 31st.
This shot for the cup and a piece of hurling history. What must be going through that young man's head? Has he got what it takes to be a champion?
About 4 years ago, my doctor said that Zocor was right for me. And since then, I've stuck with it. Ask your doctor if Zocor could work for you. Zocor, be there.
Okay, guys, get this bird put away and we're done for the day.
With a new available Power Stroke diesel, five-speed automatic torque shift transmission, and the most torque and horsepower of any diesel pickup, F-Series Super Duty goes way beyond just getting the job done. F-Series, the best-selling truck on the planet, is built for tough.
A star is born again. On Wednesday.
Wednesday, January 8th. The search is on for the next superstars in music, comedy, and modeling. Who will it be? Find out on the new Star Search. Live CBS Wednesday, January 8th.
Coming up in the Subway postgame show, Jim Dion, Dan and Boomer, scores and highlights from today. The Subway postgame show from New York after our game here in Pittsburgh. It is second down and 11 from the 19. 2 minute warning. Oh, now we call it the timeout. Wow.
Come on. And Matt Kavanaugh to the right, the offensive coordinator, Brian Billick. At some point against a defense like Pittsburgh, you have to figure it's not going to get much better. And with the crowd going crazy,
you just added fuel to the fire.
Well, with the crowd going crazy, Tim Lewis, the defensive coordinator of the Steelers, is going to let the dogs go. This is a situation where you might not always blitz, but you'll make them think every single play for the rest of this possession, the next two plays, if it's only two more plays. You're going to make Jeff Blake think that they're bringing 14 guys after him. There's Tim Lewis right there in the middle of the screen with the headset on.
Baltimore led 31-20 with just under 13 minutes to play.
And if you're talking blitz and you're talking pass rush, that's Joey Porter, 55, and Jason Gilden, 92.
19-yard line, second down and 11. Taylor in the backfield, and Blake is hit as he throws. Incomplete pass. Gilden and Higgins came like a Pittsburgh Avalanche right at Blake.
Well, Higgins is coming up from the stand-up right-end position. And there's Gilden up in the top of the screen, 92. One in the face, one on the arm. Sometimes it's not paranoia. You don't think they're after you. They are after you.
Taylor is in the backfield with Blake. Third down, 11 at the 19. And he slings a pass, caught with one hand by Randy Hines, galloping down the sideline, and he is into Pittsburgh territory at the 48-yard line. The ex-quarterback at Grambling, a 33-yard pickup.
Kevin, the first thing that comes to my mind here is Brian Billick telling us, you know what I got to say about my guys? They just don't know. Hines doesn't know what a great catch that was and what a clutch situation that was.
Carolina has won. That means Atlanta is in the playoffs in the NFC. First down, Pittsburgh 48. Baltimore with two timeouts. That's Todd Heap, the tight end, and he's at the 41. 7-yard gain. Clock is stopped with 1:39. And we now turn our attention to Matt Stover because he has kicked a season-long 51-yard field goal this year, 43 yards today.
And sometimes that don't know, you know, you don't know what you don't know. Part of that is you can overcome mistakes. You don't know that it was bad. You didn't call those timeouts at the right time. You didn't know that the, you know, penalties were hurting you earlier. All you know is you're in, it's late, and you got a shot to win or tie.
41-yard line, second down and three. Blake, a Taylor block, and outside for the Pro Bowler Heat, who gets wisely out of bounds, picks up the first down, stiff arms his way to the 31, and picks up 10 yards on the catch as he hobbles back.
Yeah, and right now, they're in field goal range of Stover. He's already stroked the one you said earlier from 43, and there's Heap right there working against Higgins. Another pretty good catch. I mean, we've seen some nice exhibitions of low grabs by the receivers of Baltimore because Blake's put the ball low where only they could get at it.
First and 10. Chester Taylor in the backfield. Baltimore at the Pittsburgh 31. Chester Taylor slashing his way down to the 26 and picks up five. Clock continues to tick. A lead block by Casey Rabach. Timeout taken by Baltimore. They've got one left. Pittsburgh has three. 1:26 to play.
Well, it's gets pretty simple right here. I mean, two options. You're going to kick a field goal or you're going to score a touchdown. Gee, what do you think they want to do? I mean, but Brian Billick wants to win this game to keep his playoff chances alive. So you're going to see him take some chances here that you might normally, and not in another situation, not see him take. And all the formulas are falling. New England's losing. Cleveland's in a trailing position to Atlanta. I mean, it's setting up the right way. But you're in field goal position right now for Stover. And you've got a running game that's working. And you got a quarterback that's clicking with his wide receivers, especially Pete, 86.
So second down and five, Baltimore with one timeout on the board. Pittsburgh, 26-yard line.
Okay, a big receiver in the important downs today for this football team has been Taylor, 89, top of the screen, a wide receiver.
Chester Taylor's in the backfield. Travis Taylor is at top of your screen. Chester Taylor. Chased by Joey Porter, bangs his way into the secondary, hit by Lee Flowers, among many, Clark Higgins, close to a first down, clock continues to roll, Baltimore with the timeout.
You know, Brian Billick took the philosophy both to his fans and with his football team last week, that that was a playoff game against Cleveland. It didn't go well late, obviously they ended up losing the game, but he's built that kind of an atmosphere for last week and for this week. This kind of experience is going to help him so much down the line next year.
Third and one. And a leaping Jamal Lewis picks up a first down, flying to the 20-yard line. Clock continues to tick as you see, and again, the Ravens with the timeout. And they do get the first down. Now they want the timeout. With 27 seconds to play. And they are out of timeouts. So now they're going to have to go outside to stop the clock so they get their field goal unit on the field.
Well, that's assuming you throw the ball in the field to play. I think anything that happens passing-wise at this point is in the end zone for the Baltimore Ravens.
Tennessee just went up on Houston by a 10-point margin, and New England just scored.
Right there. Cleveland just going ahead of Atlanta. Puts a little bit of a damper on the Baltimore scenario as far as making the playoffs.
But didn't you get the sense that Brian Billick felt that last week was a playoff game for his team? This certainly is a playoff game for this team of unknown players and young NFL experienced players.
It's the equivalent to a team this young, this inexperienced.
Baltimore took over at their own 20 with 2.5 to play. Upcoming the ninth play of the drive. First and 10.
Again, if this is a pass, it's got to happen in the end zone or on the boundaries. Nothing inbounds. No timeouts, 27 seconds. You're risking losing this thing on the clock.
Chester Taylor in the backfield. Offers a block. Blitzes on. And Blake throws to the side. And incomplete. As he was looking for Travis Taylor. Now,
Blake took a shot.
Blake down, flag down, and 21 seconds on the fourth quarter clock.
I think you have roughing the passer against Joey Porter.
The number two quarterback today is Hurts Chris Redman.
Roughing the passer. Contact to the head of the quarterback on the 55 defense.
That's on. Pro Bowler,
Joey Porter is going to be coming right from behind that pile right there. See, there's Porter, 55, coming around the end. Helmet into the face. The crowd doesn't like it, but that's kind of tough beans. You don't put helmet to helmet into a quarterback's face in this league. And Joey Porter knows that.
Huge penalty. First and goal at the 10. Redman, who has missed the last 10 games with a back injury, is the number two quarterback. He's headed for the emergency room after the season for a back operation.
Remember, last try was to Taylor, but Heap has had the jump ball that was successful.
Chester Taylor in the backfield, first and goal at the 10. Blake to the end zone and intercepted. Picked off by Dwayne Washington. interception of Jeff Blake in the end zone today.
You don't mind getting beat when you're using your best stuff. This was not the best stuff Baltimore had to offer. The best receiver in this situation is Heap. They're throwing to Taylor. The best pass is at the end of the end zone. This is throwing to Hines, number 81, the rookie. And Washington and the defensive backfield and the defensive staff is all over this play. Jeff Blake underthrows it. Hines is out of position. And Baltimore's out of luck.
Third interception by Dwayne Washington this year. Baltimore is out of timeouts. Pittsburgh Steelers have just found out that Tennessee won today in Houston. So they will have a home field playoff game. And Pittsburgh wins it after being down 31-20. Steelers win their fifth game in the last six. And now for Randy Cross and Beasley Reese, Kevin Harlan saying so long from Pittsburgh. Coming up next is the Subway postgame show from New York. And let's now go live to our studios in New York. And here's Jim.
Ravens and Steelers, two teams that growl at each other. Third and goal, Ravens opening drive at the 14th. Jeff Blake in trouble. In big trouble. Picked off by DeShay Stadium Townsend. And 22 straight games, Steelers have not surrendered an opening touchdown on the drive. Tommy Maddox picked off by Gary Baxter. He resurges his way into the end zone, but roughing the passer called on the Ravens. Pittsburgh maintains the football. They do this with it. Play action, Maddox, Hines, Ward. A lot of catch-ups, a lot of Pro Bowls, 12th touchdown catch of the year, tying a Steeler record, 7-0 Pittsburgh. Bettis not playing, famous Amos Arroway, touchdown, 17-7 Pittsburgh.
Yeah, and watch the seal block here by Alan Faneca, going to pull across the formation. The linebacker, Edgerton Hartwell, going to be the guy getting blocked. Misreads right there because of the fullback going to the right side of the defense. What a great block by Faneca.
Faneca's had a great year. Tom Maddox to Dan Paperback Kreider. Hey, it's out of his hands and into the hands of James Trapp. 24 picks this year for the Ravens. They have played opportunistic football. Next play, Ravens. Blake. I got it in the screen. To Todd Heath, the Pro Bowl tight end, the Storm and Mormon. 21 yards. Blake. That's out of the screen. But into the hands of Heath. Has Heath come on this year? What, Tom? 7 for $1.46. 24-20 Baltimore. They lead 31-20. Tommy Maddox, very nimble here.
A side of Maddox's game we didn't know he had. Scrambles right there for 21 yards.
Dan Maddox to Saraway. Runs into his own guy. Touchdown. Steelers go for two. Don't make it 31-26. Kickoff. And this is better than an onside kick because Chester Taylor. Bobo! Steelers have it. So Pittsburgh in business, third and goal at the 9. Maddox. Rolling. Finding. Antoine Randall-L. Touchdown. They make it 2-point conversion, 34-31. Blake to Randy Hines from Grambling. What a catch by Hines. 33-yard gain. Look at him, Tom.
Well, just look at the throw. Look at the catch. One hand stays in bounds. Outstanding play.
The Ravens going for the win. Blake going for the end zone rather than figuring what the heck, forget the field goal in overtime. But Dwayne Washington saves it. And so the gamble to go to the end zone does not pay off. Pittsburgh secures the number 3 seed, winning 34-31 in a wild game with a lot of turnovers, but certainly a nice 7 days for the Steelers.
Yeah, and if you're Coach Cowher again, you look at the big picture here as you go into the playoffs. Saraway, you need somebody to run the football. 104 yards off the 26 carries. Jerome Bettis may not be available with you. This is the guy who's going to have to do the work.
You know what a good game? Bad pop-up.